Michigan, the winningest program of the past century. Hail to Bowl, the victors and the maize and blue. Alabama, the Bear, the All-Americans, the pride of the South. The dawning of a new century brings fresh faces and new heroes. The Wolverines unleash a passing attack that set new standards and still can lay the rugged groundwork that says Michigan. From Musso to Humphrey, Alabama's had a legacy of great running backs, but none better than the SEC Player of the Year, the one who dons the crimson for a final time tonight. Alabama and Michigan set to light up the nights in Miami at the 66th FedEx Orange Bowl. And the lights of Miami and the celebration continues as we get set at Pro Player Stadium for what we think will be a dandy. The matchup, the Wolverines of Michigan, the Crimson Tide of Alabama. Hi again, everybody. Happy New Year from Miami. I'm Brad Nessler. This is a game that doesn't need much introduction. When you say Michigan or you say Alabama, you're talking about two of the winningest programs in college football history from two of the best conferences in college football history. My partner's Bob Greasy. He's my quarterback. Michigan's got a quarterback that's a senior. This is the way it's supposed to be. He's the leader. It's his last game in that Michigan uniform.
The first 3 years of his career at Michigan weren't so good. He was a hotshot quarterback out of California, thought he should be playing, but the last two have been very good for him. Tom Brady is the leader of this team, there's no question. He's the most valuable player. He says he's had a good week, and they're ready to play this football game.
We've seen Alabama win 12 national championships, a lot of those under Bear Bryant back in the 70s. Not a Bear Bryant type of team. This Alabama offense can mix it up.
It's power football at one snap, and the very next snap, there's three and four wide receivers spread out everywhere. The unquestioned leader of the Alabama Crimson Tide is Shaun Alexander. When he was in high school, the last two schools it came down to was Alabama and Michigan. So it's only fitting that he goes out against Michigan. He's ready.
One of the very fine players in all of college football. Third man in our crew is Lynn Swan. Swanee, it's all about tradition.
That's right, Brad, it is. And what makes great tradition are a couple of things. It could be the mystique of a program. It could be great team performance and great individual performance. But the bottom line is winning football makes a great tradition. And both these teams bring in great winning records. If you look at the number of victories, number of bowl games, wins and victories, unbeatable in the NCAA. They're outstanding. And two of the chief architects of these winning programs for Alabama, it was none other than Paul Bear Bryant, the disciplinarian, and for Michigan, Bo Schembechler, the emotional leader of this football team. Now, these two giants have shaped the futures of the people who are head coaches today in this ball game. For Alabama, Mike DeBose, in his third year, he brings Alabama in as the SEC champion, and he adds to that tradition. On the Michigan side, Lloyd Carr was an assistant under Bo Schembechler. And what Lloyd has done in 5 years is brought a national championship to Michigan, and he has brought Michigan to the Orange Bowl in their 25th consecutive bowl game. Great tradition. Both teams looking to add to that with a great victory tonight, Brad.
All right, Swanee. The Wolverines looking for their third straight 10-win season. But in their way, the champions of the Southeastern Conference. It's the 66th FedEx Orange Bowl, Michigan, Alabama, coming up after we go to John and Terry in New Orleans. Guys.
Brad, thanks a lot. The mighty Mississippi here, the Natchez cooling down as the fans get ready for Virginia Tech and Florida State in the Nokia Sugar Bowl for the national championship. We talked about that, the FedEx Orange Bowl. Those two teams, as good as any teams right now, they could be playing for the national championship, but they won't be. Now, what's been made most of here this week? Virginia Tech, first time here. Inexperienced Florida State has the experience. Does it make a difference?
Well, you know what? You can just see it in the fans. We see them out here in Bourbon Street. The Virginia Tech fans are so excited to be here. It's their first experience. You can see it in their faces. The players are the same way. How they experience this championship atmosphere is different for Virginia Tech than it is for Florida State. Will this affect how they play? We'll see.
Inexperience and experience is the theme. Just ask the quarterbacks. Virginia Tech's 19-year-old redshirt freshman Michael Vick led the nation in passing efficiency, earning the respect of his opponent.
You'd like to say, yeah, he's only a freshman. But he doesn't play that way. He doesn't act that way. When he got behind this year, he responded like a fifth-year senior, you know. And he's got such excellent athletic ability, he can get himself out of bad plays, you know. And you can't teach that.
He can do almost anything. You know, he's almost the Peter Wark at the quarterback position. You know, he can throw the deep ball. He can throw the short ball. And if it's not there, he can turn and run. He can hurt us in a lot of ways.
8 years Vic senior, the maturity of 27-year-old Chris Wenke has led FSU to 20 wins in his 21 career starts.
From anybody in my situation, should be more mature than a 19 or 20-year-old kid. If you're not, that's your own fault.
He doesn't make a lot of mistakes. Only thing about he will throw in the coverage. But he has a strong arm, but the main thing that I've seen, he's smart, smart quarterback.
Virginia Tech All-American defensive end Corey Moore had no problem telling the media the age issue is being overhyped.
I'm kind of sick of hearing about that. He's played 2 years of college football, and just because he's 27 years old, yeah, he's a mature guy. But, I mean, he's got 2 years of college experience, and most times, you know, that's not that experience to me.
There's one thing for sure. The atmosphere has had a much bigger effect on Corey Moore.
We'll talk about that with Frank Beamer, the head coach of Virginia Tech, at a halftime. But right now, let's go back to Brad and Bob.
All right, guys, welcome back to the FedEx Orange Bowl Pro Players Stadium in Miami. Alabama comes in at 10-2, having won the Southeastern Conference Championship under the SEC Coach of the Year. Mike DuBose, a linebacker in the 70s, an assistant coach here, and now the head man since 97. And on the other side, longtime Michigan assistant under Bo Schembechler, and he's got a national championship to his credit a couple seasons ago in Lloyd Carr. These two teams met the toughest schedules in all of college football in the BCS computer rankings. Alabama had the toughest schedule of all. Michigan was number two.
Alabama came through with a 10-2 record. Michigan 9-2. Tough schedule.
One with a four-game winning streak in Michigan. Alabama's won five in a row, including that throttle job of Florida that we did a month ago in Atlanta. Alabama won the toss and deferred. Michigan will get it first. And that means Ryan Pflugner will tee it up. And back deep, waiting for Michigan, Walter Cross. Perfect night for football in the 70s. Clear skies in Miami. And all the preparation these two teams have undergone since before Christmas and since back in August comes to a head as we're underway. Cross from the 11. Out across the 25 to about the 28-yard line. And that's where Michigan will go to work. Our FedEx starting lineups. The big eaters up front for the Wolverines, and they are Hutchinson and Backus on that left side, both all Big Ten performers. Brant Zeman and Mast round out the front five. Marcus Knight's the home run hitter. David Terrell, their leading receiver. Shaun Thompson, the tight end. And as Bob said at quarterback, the undisputed leader is Tom Brady. Aaron Shea lead the way for Anthony Thomas. And there's Brady making his final appearance in the maize and blue of Michigan. First down Wolverines from their own 29-yard line. Play action. They're going to throw back a screen the other way. Shea the fullback. And he got it out to about the 34-yard line. Pick up of five against an Alabama defense that doesn't give up much against the run. Number two in the country thanks to these guys. Grimes and Griffin inside. King and Moorhead are the defensive ends. A rangy linebacker core led by a freshman in the middle. Salim Rashid with Merritt and Gilbert flanking him. And the secondary, also young but getting better every week. Lewis and Dixon on the corners. Spencer and Miles are the safeties.
That Alabama defense is looking for a run early from Michigan. That's why Michigan came out throwing the football.
Second down and five, and they'll get the run. And they move it head on. Thomas maybe got a yard. That's it. Cornelius Griffin said hello. And it's going to bring up third down and four.
Don't look for Michigan to run wide. Tom Brady's going to send his crew right up at him. Alabama, too much speed to run left and right up the middle.
There's that Alabama defense, number two in the nation, allowing only 75 yards a game. And a third down and four as Michigan goes with a four wide out look. And Brady will work from the gun. Blitz coming down the middle, off the hands of the intended receiver, Diala Johnson. Incomplete. Michigan's three and out. They'll have to give it up.
The pass was there. Brady had the ball on the money. Dixon, number four, is a true freshman. They're going to be going at him all night.
Freddie Millins, a dangerous return man. He's taken one for a touchdown this year. And Hayden Epstein from behind him. We see the Michigan punt upcoming. High, lazy kick. Millens camps under it at the 19. Freddie Millens. 30. 35. Cuts outside. A shoestring tackler. He might have been off to the races, as it was a 17-yard punt return. Alabama works offensively without one of the best players in all of college football. And Chris Samuels, the Outland Trophy winner and a first-team All-American left tackle, had made 42 straight starts, hadn't given up a sack all year, and he's out, sadly enough, with a bad right knee. And you know the big fella is missing this opportunity.
Yeah, but he'll be around on the sideline. What a great individual he is, both he and Shaun Alexander.
He's a fun kid to be around.
Got to know him a little bit this week.
So Alabama, good starting field position from the 37-yard line. On the first snap, a quick slant, a man wide open, and Jason McCadley would have been off to the races, a blown coverage by Michigan, but it's just an incomplete pass.
That's good planning and scheming there.
Offense almost had a touchdown on the first play. The FedEx starting lineup, the big ones up front. Ellington takes that spot of Samuels, and Baxley will start at right tackle. Cuthbert and Redmill are the guards, and Hogan's an excellent center. Jones the tight end, McCadley, who just missed on that one, and Freddie Millens the other wide out. Andrew Zhao with Dustin McClintock, and Shaun Alexander, the player of the year in the SEC. That's McClintock on the move, and he throws a block for Alexander, who busts it out across the 40, close to the 42-yard line, where Tommy Hendricks makes the tackle for the Michigan defense that is no slouch either. Their guys up front, Renus and Wilson inside, are tough. Hall and Williams, the leading sackers. The linebacking core, they make most of the tackles thanks to that front four. And it is a good linebacking core of Hobson, Dahomey Jones, and Ian Gold. And in the secondary, Hendricks, who just made that one stop, that one safety, June the other, and Howard and Whitley are the corners.
Alabama couldn't say enough about Rob Renus, the nose tackle, just disrupting everything. Five wide receivers.
They have Millens at quarterback, and then move Zhao back in there, and he throws complete, but drops in his tracks is Antonio Carter by Dahomey Jones. And Alabama likewise loses five, and it's three and out for the tie.
The first play of the game, Alabama had an opportunity. They faked the wide receiver screen and the receiver straight downfield. They do this a lot. They show this a lot against Florida in the SEC championship game.
So Patrick Morgan to punt. That's Deano Johnson waiting on the other end. Morgan, high spiral. Johnson will call for a fair catch and take it at about the 21-yard line. 41-yard kick and no return. Will return in a moment. No score early between Michigan and Alabama.
Spanish commentary for this game can be heard using the SAP feature on your TV set where available. Brought to you by National Car Rental.
Combat Rangers. They're rough. They're tough. They're battle-tested.
Can I be a deck?
Combat Rangers.
Incoming! Cover me!
They're lean, mean fighting machines.
No!
When there's a battle to be won, Combat Rangers get the job done. Combat Rangers.
Now, tell me why they're wearing dresses.
The commander uniforms didn't arrive from China on time.
That's because you picked the wrong shipping company.
You recommended the whole
deal. Next time, use the only U.S. Express shipper with direct routes from China, FedEx. Be absolutely sure.
Is that a thong?
Oh, boy. We thought it could double as a holster.
Matching handbag, heels, and night vision tiara sold separately.
Just hit the buzzer, Andy.
I brought something for you from Pets.com.
I'm here to play with the tabby cat.
I'm not going
to
tell you what it is, but it makes you crazy. One, two, three. Oh, sorry. Pets.com, because pets can't drive.
I talked to his secretary. He can't make it.
What do you mean he can't make it?
I mean, he can't make it.
Well, if he can't make it, then we got to reschedule the meeting. I mean, this whole project was his idea. If he sees the numbers from research, he's not going to be happy.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, I get physically sick looking at these numbers. Tom, can you hold on a second?
Looking for a good time?
Okay, Tom, about the meeting.
The Civic from Honda.
Shannon Sharp, Cleveland, has always talking trash.
Japan, baby!
He's always trying to get inside your head.
Behold, you don't know your elbows from your...
And sometimes, he can get downright nasty.
I bet you pay transaction fees on your mutual funds. Your mama pays full commission. You know how to calculate a P.E. ratio.
When we created a smarter kind of investment firm...
How diversified is your portfolio?
We created a smarter kind of investor.
You can't even spell Dow Jones.
Okay, guys, let's get this right. To calculate a P/E ratio, you divide the stock price.
Tuesday, January 11th at 10, 9 Central.
Remember me?
Blue is back. The season premiere of NYPD Blue, Tuesday, January 11th on ABC.
Early stages of the first quarter. Each team has punted once. Michigan's got it back now. The Wolverines on their own 21-yard line. Tom Brady brings them out after huddling on the sideline. There's his season numbers, 19-5 as a Michigan starter. Anthony Thomas behind him on a first down. Wolverine. Play action, swings it out to the fullback's Jay. Alabama's all over that.
Yeah.
Reggie Miles with a tackle.
Yeah, that's what they want to do. They want to throw in run situations, throw to set up the run, a pass to set up the run. Bama's got nine guys up there on the line of scrimmage. Bama wants to get off the field. They've had some injuries. Depth is a problem. Michigan is a physical offense that Alabama worries about being worn down if they stay on the field too long.
Ellis Johnson, their defensive coordinator, says we don't want to be looking at those guys in the fourth quarter having been on the field the whole night.
That's right.
Second down and 11. Now the inside handoff. Thomas trying to bust it outside, but they're not going to let him. Darius Gilbert holds on. Number 99, the sophomore, brings him down, but still a pickup for Anthony Thomas of 5. Thomas looking for his fifth straight 100-yard game. His sixth straight, rather, has 5. There's his season numbers.
He is a tough kid. Not only can he carry the ball, and he carries it about 80% of the rushing yards comes from him, but he is a good blocker on blitzes, blocking for the quarterback.
Brady from the gun now, third down and 6. With 4 wideouts, he fires it out to the outside. Terrell. And they're going to bring him down well short of the first down.
Maybe to
the 28.
And what I'm seeing early, Brad, is the speed of the defense for Alabama. They are just getting to the ball and not letting anything get away. Two receivers at the top of the screen on the left. The ball comes to Terrell, number 1. The red shirts get around the block of Hutchinson. And they just there. They run well left to right.
Freddie Millen's first one. He returned 17 yards. Epstein again to punt. High kick. Millen's is going to have to fair catch this one. And comes up on it at about the 39-yard line. So Michigan, 2 possessions, 6 plays, 2 punts. And Alabama will have it back on offense. We'll see if number 37 gets rolling when we come back.
Better time than now to get the good life at Sears. So don't miss out on the best time to buy. Get 0% financing on all Kenmore appliances over $399 till May 2000 when you use your Sears card. Like this Kenmore washer and dryer. You save $120 on the pair and you get free delivery. Sears, the good life at a great price. Guaranteed. Sears is the proud sponsor of the BCS and the Sears National Champion Football Trophy.
We've had success with that.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Our company's made huge strides in e-commerce.
No, no, who hasn't?
We've got web-based order tracking. We can analyze our customer data in all kinds of ways. I mean, it's amazing.
Oh, yeah. Well, but the same with us.
Yeah. So how did you guys integrate your ERP?
Burp?
Confused about e-business? Don't be. Get the software, services, and partners that make it easier. The business internet starts with Microsoft.
The FedEx Orange Bowl. This ABC Sports exclusive brought to you by Charles Schwab. When we created a smarter kind of investment firm, we also created a smarter kind of investor. Sears and the Sears National Champion Football Trophy. AT&T, one rate, 7-cent plan. One simple rate all day, every day. and Honda, a winning lineup of cars, sport utility vehicles, and minivans.
As they used to say in the Jackie Gleason Show, from the fun and sun capital of the world, Miami Beach.
I like that.
Those guys had some fun this week. Out on the beach, the linemen stayed off the jet skis for the most part. They're a little too heavy for those things. Alabama picked up a couple of yards on the possession. They start from the 39 now with Tyler Watts at quarterback.
Alternating like they did in the SEC championship game.
High backfield behind him. And they'll give it straight ahead to McClintock, the fullback. And he goes for about 4 yards. That first play of the game, Bob, Alabama could have had a touchdown.
Yeah, last, watch this. They're going to throw the ball out here backwards, and the receiver's just going to go downfield. He's going to slide by. Watch the two yellow-shirted pants. The defense comes up. They were planning. They saw a lot of that from Alabama in the championship game, where they just threw out that wide receiver screen, so they were ready for it. Nice little innovation to start the game. Just didn't connect.
Andrew Zhao, I think, just got eyes the size of saucers when he saw what could have been and overthrew him. Now penalty markers as Alabama appeared to be in motion. Our referee, Chuck McFerrin from the Pac-10.
Dead ball, false start on the offense, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
So second down and longer as we look at the Dell Game Solutions, Bob.
Yeah, Alabama, the quarterbacks must play smart. Michigan tries to be a confusing, disguising defense. They got to play smart, and for Michigan defensively, they want to force the quarterbacks to have to win the game through the pass by taking the run away from them.
So Tyler Watts, a redshirt freshman at the controls with a second and 11 now. They'll work with three wide receivers. Freddie Millen's in motion, and it's a pitch to Alexander the other way. Shaun Alexander breaks the tackle, fighting his way out near the 45-yard line. And a penalty marker down. Cato June brought him down, a pickup of 7. We're shoving after the play. Again, you see the diversification of the Alabama offense. It's a holding call that'll negate that run. When they put Millens in motion, it gave Michigan the look that maybe he was going to get the handoff on an end around. They pitched it the other way.
Holding on a run beyond the line, 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul.
That's going to be a big one when you consider where the spot of the penalty was.
Yeah, they've been penalized a lot this year. In fact, they're near the bottom of the list, being the most penalized in the conference.
More than they ever have in Alabama history, and that encompasses a lot of games and a lot of victories. Beautiful look into Pro Players Stadium for this 66th FedEx Orange Bowl at the 30-yard line now. Alabama backed up to a second down and 19.
Four wide receivers down here to the bottom of the screen.
Watts looking that way. Throws out to Millens. Hoping for some blocks. Got one, but that was about it. Maybe got 3 yards. Michigan's defense waiting for him. Good job defensively by Ronald Bellamy.
In the SEC championship game, they did some of this too. Look at the three wide receivers here at the top and the two down at the bottom. Three stacked behind each other at the top. Then they have Millens at quarterback. You know, would Joe Namath and Kenny Stabler love to have had some of those formations?
I would guess so.
Huh?
Third down and 16 now. McCantley in motion, watched from the gun under pressure, fires a wideout screen to Millens, and he goes down again. Michigan's defense doing a great job. Dehani Jones was there to meet him, and Alabama's got to give it up. In fact, they lost yardage on that possession.
Both teams are just trying to get the butterflies out of their systems. Alabama doing a nice job of just throwing the ball around, giving their skill players, Millens and their speed guys, an opportunity to break something.
Four total possessions in the game, all have been three and outs. Morgan to punt. Nice kick. Johnson will have to fair catch. And all we're doing is changing kicks here. A 38-yard punt down to the 28-yard line. Michigan will have it on offense when we come back to Miami in a moment.
Hi, I'm Chris Carter. I'd like to talk to you about a problem that can happen in your city, your community, to someone you love.
The inability to tell the difference between a bid price and an ask price, a market order and a limit order.
But thanks to programs like WebShop, Schwab is making a difference. At Schwab branches across America, they'll teach you all about using the world's leading online broker. Pay attention.
just another way Schwab is helping to make smarter investors.
How do you look up a stock symbol again?
Amazing things can happen when you push the right buttons. Introducing the 240 horsepower S2000 Roadster from Honda.
Every year I say, I'm going to quit smoking. Day later, I'm at it again. Till this year. See this? My last piece of Nicorette gum. Been smoke-free with Nicorette now for 12 weeks. With Nicorette, I help control my cravings two ways. I used it on a regular schedule to help curb them. And then for unexpected cravings, I took another piece. And now, no more craving, no more nicotine. Happy New Year.
For a better quit date, you'll have to wait another 1,000 years. You can do it. Nicorette can help.
Your webpage will even make you feel differently according to how it is positioned. For example, here, the yin is strong. Coolness, peace. Whereas over here, the yang is there, powerful, hot. And now, up here, the computer's just happy.
Who designs your website is up to you. Hooking it up and delivering the goods, leave that up to us.
You'll ship everything. FedEx.
FedEx. Be absolutely sure.
This is the FedEx Orange Bowl.
No score early. Charles Schwab will make contributions to the scholarship funds of each of the universities represented in the bowl championship series. No score, Alabama and Michigan. We're in the first quarter with 7:31 remaining in the 66th FedEx Orange Bowl from Pro Players Stadium in Miami. Brad Nessler, Bob Greasy, Lynn Swan, and our ABC crew here. And neither team has mustered anything offensively so far. They both had the ball twice. They both had to punt twice.
The Alabama defense has three true freshman starters in the lineup. Ellis Johnson putting him in after injuries took out some veteran ball players. There's a look at the true freshman players, all but Tyler Watts, a true freshman, having to play this year for Alabama.
That's how good they might be next year. Here's a throw by Brady, and it's complete across the 35. Out near the 37-yard line of Marquise Walker, a pickup of 9, still a little bit short of the first down. They wanted to get Tom Brady off early in this game, Bob.
They did, and they wanted to do it by throwing short, throwing the ball around, get him off to some good numbers. Every quarterback likes to go out and hit his first few, be 4 out of 5 and moving the ball, but neither team has made a first down yet.
Michigan's closing in on one, third down and a yard. Thomas and Shea behind Brady. Alabama may have jumped in the neutral zone. Here's Anthony Thomas. Boy, if he got it, he had to earn it because he got popped right at the line of scrimmage. Darius Gilbert and Jamie Carter made the hit.
Alabama is just inviting Michigan to throw the football. 8 guys in the box that time against the run.
I don't think he got it, but we'll wait and see.
Carter, number 90, is one of the biggest ones.
It is fourth down. Well, Michigan came up about 2 feet short, and they'll have to punt again. Epstein to kick. Nobody's back for Alabama right now. And it is a fake punt. That's why they weren't back, and Michigan picked it up. Out across the 40 to the 42-yard line. Ian Gold took the direct snap. On fourth down and a couple feet, Lloyd Carr, you'd have to smile about that one.
A rare smile on the sideline from Lloyd Carr. You know, he really didn't have anybody fooled. Alabama, like you said, didn't have anybody back. They've seen this before, Alabama has. Epstein does the Academy Award like it's over his head. He doesn't fool anybody.
Well, there's our first down of the ball game. It comes on a little bit of a trick play by Michigan. They got it at the 42-yard line. Brady now from the gun with 3 wideouts. Top sets and fires his safety valve. Thomas out there in the flat. He swarmed under a loss on the play. Miguel Merritt got out there to make the tackle. Coming up tomorrow night, the BCS continues on ABC. Eric Crouch, what a game and a season he's had at T. Martin for Tennessee, as Nebraska and the Volunteers will come to you tomorrow night live at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. Get complete post-game analysis at abcsports.com, a part of the GO Network. That ought to be a dandy, too.
Tennessee revisits where they won their national championship last year.
Second down at 11, Michigan. Here's a toss sweep to Tice. Turns on the speed, but so does Salim Rashid.
That kid is a true freshman. He is, if he's not the youngest on the team, he's certainly close to it. He's 18 years old.
When Marvin Constant went down to injury, they moved number 11 to the middle linebacker position, and he made a bunch of plays like this one.
This is why Michigan can't run from one side to the other. The speed in the middle. He leads the team in tackles. Not that big. He's only 217 pounds, middle linebacker.
They expect to move him back outside once Constant is injury-free next year.
And coming
with a blitz. Penalty markers down, though they may have been offside. The pass incomplete, intended for Marcus Knight. Looked like Miguel Merritt jumped in that neutral zone. They've been hopping around, showing blitz and coming with a blitz and being a little bit happy in that neutral zone. Let's see if they got caught that time.
Defense lined up in the neutral zone. 5-yard penalty.
That's the call.
Still third down.
Michigan gets five out of it. It's the third penalty against Alabama.
When the coach from the sideline, Ellis Johnson, sends in a blitz, all the defensive players love that. I mean, so they're anxious, and they get up there, and they want to get to the quarterback first. And
they're down in their tracks.
They're just a little anxious. I mean, the key is not to show it if you're coming.
Third down at five. They show a three-man rush is all here now. Brady may have changed things at the line of scrimmage as he drops to throw. Getting some pressure. Fires back over the middle. Penalty markers down. It'll be a first down if they don't bring it back. It's complete to the fullback, Shea. Might be a holding call, though, on Michigan. So what they just picked up one way, they might have to go the other way with.
Ellis Johnson going to a 3-6-2. It was third and five, and he dropped six defenders right around the first down marker, about 6 or 7 yards downfield.
Personal foul, face mask on the offense.
Face
15
mask
yards
the
from
offense.
The spot
Something
of the foul.
You don't see very often.
15 yards, too.
Wow.
Right there. There it is.
There it
right
is.
Here.
Good call. That's Zeman.
Zeman on Moorhead. And quarterbacks don't mind your offensive lineman holding to protect them.
Check in with Swanick.
Well, Brad, watching that offensive face mask penalty, and I think one of the reasons why that's occurring is we're seeing tremendous speed by both defenses on this football field. The intensity is unbelievable. All 11 guys on the defense are moving around so quickly, they just look like blurs coming across the field. And if they can keep this intensity up for four quarters of football, we're going to have to get stretchers to carry them off the field when the game's over.
That's a good point. I was watching some of those games today, and I think the Purdue-Georgia game in Tampa, the humidity got to some of those guys, and I think the game was much slower in the fourth quarter.
From the gun on 4-26, Brady fires behind Terrell, the intended receiver. Reggie Miles was right there defensively, and pressure coming from Kenny King, number 55. And Michigan, after picking up one first down, now has to punt it away again.
Yeah, Kenny King, number 55. The defensive end, as you mentioned, a true freshman, beating Backus. Just gets back there to say hello to Tom Brady.
Another all-SEC freshman team member, Kenny King. Epstein's a busy punter already here in the new century. Low snap. He got some pressure on him that time. This might be returnable for Millens, but he has to back away now as it took a bounce in front of him.
Yeah, Michigan was lucky that ball hit the ground because Millen had a lot of room between he and the defenders.
Neither team has gotten its offense going. We'll see if Shaun Alexander can get in gear when we come back.
AT&T, 7 cents a minute, all day, every day.
Take one of these, that'll be 25 cents.
But it says here it's a nickel.
Not for a couple of hours.
What?
Well, see, sometimes it's a nickel, but right now,
It's a quarter.
It's like that long-distance nickel plan where they say it's a nickel.
Sometimes they charge you 25.
That's right.
That's where we got the idea.
Is that right?
7 cents a minute, all day, every day, even to Canada with our international plan.
You know, there are some stores that sell candy for one low price all day long.
And people like it?
Oh, they love it.
Call 1-800-41-RATE to enroll.
Speed. That's what business is all about. How fast can you zap your email? How fast can you zap your competitors? How fast can you eat your breakfast? How fast can you eat your competitor's lunch? To the business traveler, it's all about speed. That's why you should join National Car Rentals Emerald Club. You get to bypass the counter, go straight to the Emerald Isle, take the car of your choice, and go. National calls it Emerald Club. But you'll call it a great way to rent a car. One fast world, one very fast car rental company. Let's go!
It is more than a trial by fire. It is a rite of passage. And if you can master your fear, outsmart your enemy, and never yield, even to yourself, you will be changed forever. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Now that's a plan. You gave me the idea? Well, maybe I vaguely inspired something. We used to charge different prices at different times.
Like that long-distance nickel plan.
Sometimes it's a nickel, sometimes it's a quarter.
But you changed because you wanted to be more like
AT&T. 7 cents a minute, all day, every day.
Oh, you're the man.
Yeah, you're the candy man.
You're the 7 cents man.
Well, every child has a dream.
7 cents a minute, all day, every day. Even to Canada with our international plan. Call 1-800-41-RATE to enroll.
Another one of those true freshmen, a 300-pounder, Dante Ellington, filling in for the Outland Trophy winner, Chris Samuels, at the left tackle spot for Alabama.
Ellington has started every game this year at the right tackle position. Samuels always played the left, so Ellington moves over now and plays the left. So that's something new for him.
Once again, we're trying to call a timeout. They may have gotten it called. You saw right in the middle of the screen trying to get a timeout call. I don't know if they didn't have enough players on the field or whatever.
Timeout, Michigan.
They did get it right before the snap. Alabama came out. Andrew Zhao came up under center, and you can see the timeout call by Hall right there.
I don't think they had enough players out there.
I don't think so either. There's the guy we're talking about. You don't miss, take number 60 out of the lineup, not expect to miss him, Bob, the way he's played this year.
He's been outstanding. He was voted the best offensive lineman in the country, winning the Outland Trophy.
Didn't give up a sack all year and led the way for guys like Shaun Alexander.
What Alabama has done is they've moved Dante Ellington, the right tackle, the freshman, over to the left to take Samuel's spot. And then they had to move in a redshirt freshman who has not played much this year. Ralston has been in there. And Baxley is also, 76 is in there now, Baxley. So really, you've got the two tackle positions are being manned by freshmen. One a true freshman and the other a redshirt freshman.
It's a good thing to look forward to for next year, but for the time being, it's a little risky against a Michigan defense that's pretty stingy, or has been so far tonight. From the 31, is again Alexander. At about three, Josh Williams made the tackle.
The reason for that timeout earlier, because Michigan didn't have enough corners on the field. Here's a look at Ellington, number 65.
And a little piece of the linebacker, and then shoved him right at the end.
Yeah, you know, the thing I'm impressed with is how big he is and how quick his feet were. You saw him get through the hole and how his feet moved. Whenever you have a big man that can move his feet, you've got a good player. Yep.
Second down at 7. We're under 2.5 minutes in the first quarter. Still no score. Alabama still looking for a first down as Zhao rolls to throw. Fires deep on the sideline. Incomplete. Intended for Shamari Buchanan. And incomplete. Coming up Monday night on ABC, it's the finale to the 30th anniversary season of Monday Night Football. Will it be the final hurrah for that great player in a 49er uniform? Jerry Rice. And the 49ers take on the Atlanta Falcons, 9 o'clock Eastern, from the Georgia Dome, site of the Super Bowl. And hey, if you want to join ABC Sports in Atlanta for the Super Bowl, watch Monday Night Football for all the details this Monday night. But remember, you got to watch to win. And another third down coming up for Alabama. Third and 7, they're 0 for 2 tonight. 43% on the season. They'll keep it on the ground. And Freddie Williams got a first down and broke a tackle. Out to the 45-yard line. Gold finally brought him down, but he got 11.
You never know what Alabama is going to come out in. And one time on first down, they'll come out in fullback. This time, they've got three backs in the backfield. The only thing is, Millens is the tailback. Right here, Millens, the wide receiver, is the tailback carrying the football. He's very impressed with the different plays that Alabama has ready to go for this ball game.
Longest play of the game so far. Freddie Millens, 11-yard scamper. First down out just across the 45-yard line. I think we've got a play clock snafu. Our first Y2K thing of the game. Other than the way these offenses have had a few bugs in them so far. First and 10, though, Alabama. Zau fell down, but he got the hand off to Alexander. Penalty markers in the middle of the fray, and Shaun only got about two. Josh Williams went on the hit. It's a holding call on Alabama. That's your fourth penalty.
Yeah. These offensive penalties, especially the major ones, will kill you. And it could be the new tackles. There's a look at Baxley. He's a redshirt freshman we talked about. He's manning the right tackle position. Ellington moves over to the left. And when you move, the choice was when Samuels was going out to leave Ellington on the right side and put in Baxley or Ralston on the left. You just have one new player at one new position. But when you move Ellington over from right to left, he's not real used to that position either.
Holding call backs it up to first down at 22. From the shotgun, now with the handoff inside, Alexander got back to the original line of scrimmage. Now Hunter Jones made the tackle. And that'll bring up second down in a mile. They need to get all the way to the 45-yard line of Michigan for a first down. Second and 21. Now watch again, alternating series tonight. Carter hustles out. The play comes in. Bowens from the bench. Still the four wide receiver look as Alexander moves over into a slot on the left side for Andrew Zau. Pressure across the middle to Alexander.
I like that play. You can't get anything running. Get Alexander out. Just throwing the ball in broken field. Let him run. He's caught 25 balls this year. Caught 61 in his career.
Use the umpires a little bit of his
career. Use anything you can get. There he is right here. 37. Just going to go across the formation. Now use your good tackling by Michigan. Nobody overcommitted. They waited until some more Michigan players came around and just group tackle this guy.
Well, it maybe made the third down a little more manageable, but it's still a long ways to go. Third down at 13. Three wideouts out here to the near side. Zau looking that way, has plenty of time. Fires down the middle high, incomplete. Intended for Shamar Buchanan. Alabama's got to kick it away again.
Well, the good news, the bad news is the offenses haven't done anything. The good news is they haven't turned it over.
That's right.
You know, punting is not a bad thing. You know, the offensive coordinators, when you're playing good defenses, you gotta sink that into your quarterbacks. Punting is okay.
If this is a good punt by Morgan, Alabama will have at least gained a little bit of field position.
We got down here. You have two guys and only one guy come covering
them. Morgan, penalty markers down off the side of his foot. A terrible kick.
That was a real shame.
I guess.
That thing went dead right. I don't think he got 10 yards on that kick.
It was like one of my tee shots. Maybe he just took off.
Both kickers for Alabama are walk-ons. Both are seniors. And they just awarded scholarships this past season.
Let's see what the penalty marker is about. Illegal formation on Alabama. And that one went flying out of bounds at about midfield. Mike DeBose not liking what he sees from his not-so-special teams. Our aerial view with courtesy of the Goodyear Tire and Rubber Company. Overhead is Goodyear's blimp, Stars and Stripes, continuing his 75-year tradition of making appearances at major events. He's given us a crystal-clear shot down in the Pro Players Stadium. That was a loss of one on that punt.
Minus one on the punt.
We don't see many of those.
Oh, might be a record.
Michigan, good starting field position. That'll be the final play of the quarter here for Brady and the Wolverines offense. Thomas all wrapped up by Miguel Merritt, who's had a good first quarter for the Alabama defense. And the quarter comes to a close. A defensive battle so far. No score. This ABC Sports presentation of the FedEx Orange Bowl will continue after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
After weeks of searching through remote territories, my efforts were rewarded. I noticed something moving in the brush, traveling nimbly across the rugged terrain. A group of nomadic males, strong, powerful, magnificent. They truly are impressive beasts.
Need more room for your tools? Here's a quick fix. Head to Sears now during the best time to buy. This Craftsman Project Center is just $99.99. Save $60. Sears, proud sponsor of the Bowl Championship Series and the Sears National Champion Football Trophy.
Come on, I see the delivery for the parakeet. Let me go surprise him.
No.
Come on.
What if I gave you $3?
How much?
$4.
Pets.com, because pets can't drive.
Celebrating 2000. Channel 2 Action News all day, all night.
We will be here at the Y2K Command Center throughout the weekend.
Live Team 2 coverage from Georgia to Times Square and all around the world.
We've been preparing for this moment since 1996.
Channel 2 Action News salutes those who made Georgia Y2K ready.
When the clock rolled over, there were no problems.
Happy New Year, Georgia!
Channel 2 Action News, millennium coverage you can count on.
Family. If you're lucky, you'll remember the little moments that were good.
Are you in the mafia?
I'm in the waste management business.
I got a bad feeling.
People are gonna get murdered.
I'm trying to do the right thing by you. You're trying to be what?
I don't want to die out.
How are you feeling now?
Good. Fine. Back at work.
Or 100 anytime minutes. With prices this low, nothing surprises me anymore.
Meet Georgia's first baby of the new year on the Night Beat.
ABC's coverage of the FedEx Orange Bowl.
No score through a quarter, thanks to some stingy defense. As we look at our AT&T team comparison, a lot of defense there, Robert.
Yeah, not much offense. Michigan, no third down conversions. Only one of eight on third down by both teams. Michigan not being penalized too much. Alabama's got the worst of it. This drive started on Alabama's 42-yard line, by far the best field position for the Wolverines.
Only the second play run in plus territory tonight by either team. Second down and 11, and again, coming through there, Darius Gilbert crashing in. Let's see who the penalty is going to be against. Michigan backing up.
Dead ball. False start on the offense. Five-yard penalty. Still second down.
You know, Bob, another thing is we saw Alabama play a month ago. It's been longer than that for Michigan. Both teams look that way, right?
Yeah, it does. It's tough. When you stop playing a season, you're playing every week, and then you stop for a month, and then you try to come back, and you get that timing back. It's easier defensively than it is on offense, and it's showing here tonight.
Second down and 16. Michigan. Shea, the fullback in motion. Here's Thomas and the give to Terrell on the end around. Got a block from his quarterback. Penalty marker down. Terrell still on his feet, and he's near a first down, but again, a flag near midfield.
Going to be a, I think it's going to be a clipping. saw Michigan running this in practice the other day. The only problem was, I mean, it looked good. The only problem was the speed on the defense against Michigan the other day wasn't as good as
that's
this
right.
In the red shirts out here.
Here's a give to Thomas and then Terrell on the end around. Brady leading the way there.
That's a good block.
There's the holding at the top of the screen. Yeah. So the holding call negates what would have been the first down. And Michigan's got another penalty on its offense.
And they're moving in the wrong direction. These offenses, I think Michigan needs just to line up, drop back, and throw the ball to their wide receivers.
Yep.
I think they need to open this up. Because on offense, running the ball, they're not getting anything done. Go back to what we said in the Dell Game Solutions, throw to set up the run, and they just need to throw for the next five or six plays and get something going.
Second and 27, way back at their own 40 from the shotgun. Brady getting some pressure, and down he goes. And it's Jared Johnson there to sack him.
Well, there was nobody open downfield. There were four receivers. Brady was sacked 24 times. Michigan gave up 24 sacks during the season. Johnson is the guy that tipped that ball in the SEC championship game that resulted in an interception for a touchdown. Right up the middle. But inside of Backus, number 79.
Another true freshman.
Yes.
So from a first down at the 42, and the play clock now is going to run out on Michigan as well. They went from a first down at the 42 of Alabama to a third down back at their own 33.
So they'll use the same kicker since he does
the leg game.
Both field goals and punting.
5 yards.
But it looked like he might be in position for a field goal to start the drive, and now he's going to... He may not punt the ball as far as where their original drive started.
That's right. Everything going wrong for the Wolverines right now. Now the line of scrimmage is the 28-yard line. And Tom Brady's got to put it a long way downfield if he's going to pick up the first down. Third down and 40. There aren't many in the playbook for that one.
Throw the ball downfield. Defensive holding gets you a first down.
Fires down the middle. Complete. And only to the 39-yard line of Marcus Knights. Miguel Merritt again there helping on the tackle. Michigan, after having great field position to start the second quarter, finds itself, as Bob said, punting from inside their own 20 now. Epstein right about on his own 20-yard line. Freddie Millens waits on the other end. Maybe it'll take a special teams play to fire this game up. Great punt. But was it too far?
He can do it.
Millens from the 17. One step back. And then comes forward, but got only the 23-yard line. That's coverage by the Wolverines. Ian Gold made the tackle. No score in Miami.
Ladies and gentlemen, your starting 5'7'1", Patrick Ewing. 6'11", Marcus Camby. 6'7".
They forgot to change the floor again.
Now there's a whole new way to snack and kick back. Introducing single-serving Tostitos snack kits. Just be sure you pick the right time to eat them. Dig in, kick back, Tostitos.
Ewing, live to the hoop.
What a day for a daydream. What a day for a daydreaming boy. And I'm lost in a daydream.
Jeep Cherokee. How will it change you? Now get all this at no extra charge.
Tom and Audrey Darcy just bought 21 acres. On which they plan to build their dream house. But if they could see a complete picture of all their accounts and assets, they'd manage their money differently, and they'd break ground a lot sooner. See how we earn it. Solomon Smith Barney.
3 years ago, my IT guys told me there'd be two kinds of businesses. Those with a vision to master the internet, and those without. And we didn't want to be the second kind. Then Dell came to see us. They showed us how to use the internet for direct relationships with our customers, suppliers, everyone who's a part of our business. With Dell's support, there's no limit to where I can take this company. We always knew we needed the internet. We just didn't know how badly.
Be direct. Dell.
Dell servers use Intel Pentium 3 processors.
It's the start of a brand new century.
The next millennium will be spectacular.
Time for one show that's ahead of its time. An all-new Sports Night, Tuesday, January 11th on ABC.
Our Aflac trivia question for this Orange Bowl. Who are the three players from either Michigan or Alabama to be named Super Bowl Most Valuable Player? We'll have the answer for you in a few minutes. Think that one over. There have been some great ones over the years. College careers that have gone on to pro careers. Here's Tyler Watts now as they alternate quarterbacks again for Alabama. They work first down on their own 24-yard line. They've had the ball seven times. They've punted seven times. Here's a counter to Alexander, trying to get him going. He got the corner, Shaun Alexander, across the 40. Midfield and all the way down to the 44-yard line of Michigan. James Whitley brought him down. The number 37 goes for 32.
Take a look at the inside blocking by that offensive line. Hogan, 74, blocking on Rinas, 58. Does a nice job man-on-man to get the block. That starts it. Then outside, you get a block by McClintock, the number 30, the fullback. Power inside and some speed outside with a little vision and some shiftiness. Shaun Alexander's a great runner.
And a first down and now penalty markers, and Watts got leveled by Rob Rinas after the flags flew in there.
Dead ball, illegal snap on the offense.
Alabama.
5-yard penalty. Still first down.
Shaun Alexander, the biggest play of the ball game so far, and a guy that's made a ton of big plays for Alabama. 15 school records. Their leading rusher all time, passing Bobby Humphrey this year. He's accounted for 50 career touchdowns. And 15 100-yard rushing games also ties the school market. He is one special young man to be around.
Just a nice kid.
Yep. First down at 15. Four of Alabama's five penalties have been on the offense. Here's a toss to Alexander. And again, he broke a tackle inside the 40, and he's down near a first down. Ian Gold brought him down, but Shaun Alexander's getting warmed up.
Shaun was saying the other day that when he took his recruiting trip to the University of Michigan, he almost went to Michigan, that my son Brian Greasy and Scott Dreisbach, another quarterback, were the two guys that were recruiting him. He said he almost went there. He said, but just felt better at Alabama.
Six carries now for 57 yards. Swanee. Second down and just a yard. Alexander again trying to follow his fullback. I think he got the first down. Let's check in with Lynn Swan.
Brad, one of the things that scares every coach about Shaun Alexander, what we just saw from him, you go after him, he pounds a line, he's got the power, he's got the size to power run on the inside. He hits that line extremely hard. But once he sees an opening, he's got the kind of speed that he gets to the outside, he takes off, and he leaves everybody in the dust. Now, this is a combination that's hard to beat in a solid running back because you don't have to substitute for a power game and you don't have to substitute for a speed game. It's all contained in number 37.
That's a good point. As Bob said earlier, a great receiver out of the backfield. He got the first down, not by much.
And Alabama has always liked to run left. Normally because Chris Samuels is on that side, right. But now because Dante Ellington, their most experienced tackle, is over there at the left tackle spot.
And they've been leading that big fullback, McClintock, along the way, too.
And the other guys, Redmill and Hogan and Cuthbert in there, are doing a nice job, too.
Now a shift at the last minute, and Jones, the tight end, is in motion on first down. Play action, Watts scrambling around. Now he's going to take off inside the 30. And out of bounds with another Alabama first down. The Tide's got something rolling here. Pickup of 11.
Tyler Watts, the redshirt freshman, came in the second half of the Auburn game and fired him up and led him to victory in that one.
And the take on him is that he will tuck it and run with it a little bit quicker than Zaudi did there.
That's exactly right. When you have a quarterback that has the ability to scramble out of the pocket and get downfield or buy some time behind the line of scrimmage, it causes problems for a defense.
So another first down, Alabama, at the 23-yard line of Michigan. Deepest penetration by either team, and Watts sees something he doesn't like. He'll call a timeout. With 11 minutes and 5 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Still no score in Miami, but Alabama threatening.
Combat Rangers. They're rough. They're tough. They're battle-tested. They're lean, mean fighting machines. When there's a battle to be won, Combat Rangers get the job done. Making backyards safe for democracy.
Now, tell me why they're wearing dresses.
The commando uniforms didn't arrive from China.
That's because you picked the wrong shipping company.
Next time, use the only U.S. Express shipper with direct routes from China, FedEx. Be absolutely sure.
Matching Night Vision Tiara sold separately.
Well, when I got hurt in this work, I thought I had supplemental insurance.
Supplemental insurance? What's that?
Aflac.
Well, even best insurance doesn't give you cash to cover things like lost pay, other expenses. This does.
What does?
Aflac.
Shouldn't ask about it at work.
Really? And what's it called?
Aflac!
Aflac. Without it, no insurance is complete.
Aflac.
The Chrysler Sebring Convertible. Engineered from the top down to be driven 365 days a year. No matter how bad the weather. Because even the wettest spot on Earth has its day in the sun. Now, lease a Chrysler Sebring JX Convertible for $329 a month.
The FedEx Orange Bowl. This ABC Sports exclusive brought to you by FedEx. FedEx, be absolutely sure. Dell Computer, pioneering direct internet ideas for your business. Be direct, Dell. New Tostitos snack kits, a whole new way to dig in, kick back. Inspire technology with a human touch. Nokia, connecting people. And Chrysler, giving you back the romance of driving.
From high above Pro Player Stadium, these pictures are from the Goodyear Blimp Stars and Stripes. It's a 75-year-old tradition for the Goodyear Blimps to make appearances at major events. Great to have you along with us tonight, guys. Boyd Carr, his team, finds itself back up to its own 23-yard line as Alabama's offense got in gear on this drive, courtesy of Shaun Alexander mostly. It's a first down at the 23. There's Shaun Alexander. 58 yards on 7 carries so far. Blitz coming. Watts steps up around the pressure, and he'll take off again. Inside the 10. He's got a first and goal, Alabama. Watts goes for 16 yards on the scramble.
It was a bootleg, and he was trying to get out to his two wide receivers who were covered. And Watts does the next best thing when you've got the ability. Just take off upfield. Almost. He runs into his old man. That's Jones. Here comes the pressure by Williams. He had to run into his tight end Jones downfield block, and he could have gotten into the end zone.
Antonio Carter brings in the play from the bench. It's first and goal just outside the 7. There's the red zone offense so far for Alabama this year. They'll give it. Shaun Alexander cuts back inside the 5, near the 4. James Hall is holding on there.
Patience. A good example right there of a great running back showing you patience. Nothing was there early. Michigan, Jones is 55, Gold is 20. Nothing's there. Doesn't run out of bounds. Doesn't get much with it, but has the patience.
So far in the game, Shaun Alexander, on this drive, has 50 yards. And the football just tucked inside the 5-yard line on the second and goal. He'll get it again. Alexander, touchdown, Alabama. He got him close, and he got him in from 5 yards out. Touchdown, Shaun Alexander, his 40th of the year.
Got some nice blocks from his wide receivers and from the fullback.
Ryan Flutner for the point after. High snap, handled well, kick is good. It took us until 9:48 remaining in the first half. But the All-American and the best back Alabama's ever had just put him in the end zone. It's 7-0 tied.
Not just as a family vehicle, but as a personal and individual means of transportation.
The throb of a powerful engine.
Now for a moment, imagine yourself as driver of this automobile.
You really have to drive it.
At the Chrysler Proving Ground,
give them an expressway, and the drivers are, I think we've made the scenic back roads fun to drive.
Or give them any country or suburban road, rough or smooth.
They're the type of people who like the feel of a fine machine.
The renowned engineers of Chrysler.
A minimum of ornamentation and a minimum of chrome moldings.
He's a regular firecracker.
The sounds of nature sing their prettiest over the rich, throaty obligato of his engine.
Even sheet metal can have a soul.
And they give you back the romance of driving.
And that is why these will never land on an ordinary car.
And you find out what exceptional unity of man and machine has been achieved.
Before I quit smoking, I asked my doctor, is Nicorette safe? And he said, of course Nicorette is safe. Smoking is not. Nicorette has been proven safe and effective in dozens of clinical trials. And Nicorette offers the Committed Quitter Support Program, which my doc said is clinically proven to increase my chances of success by up to 50%. And when he told me that only Nicorette comes in mint, I knew that that was the right choice for me. So I took my doctor's advice, and you know what? It worked.
You can do it. Nicorette can help.
At Nokia, we've discovered our phones are a lot like pets. They somehow seem to resemble their owners. Nokia. Connecting people.
These bowl games are great. These guys really know how to play.
College boys, big deal. Can they do this?
They could, but being college boys, they choose not to.
With Bob Greasy and Lynn Swann, I'm Brad Nessler. 9:48 remaining in the half. And now it's a 7-0 Alabama game, courtesy of Shaun Alexander. That's Walter Cross waiting on Lane Bearden's kick. Far side of the field. Just before he went out of bounds, he fields it and gets it out across the 20, out to the 25-yard line. Well, the majority of that drive, 76 yards, all running plays by Alabama, and a good majority by the SEC Player of the Year. Shaun Alexander ripped that one run off for 32 yards. That got him heading in the right direction, and he's been their offense tonight, including that 5-yard touchdown.
Getting some nice blocking from his wide receivers, Bowens in particular.
Half the 76-yard march in 7 plays. Now let's see if Michigan's got an answer. Brady sets up on first down and fires incomplete, intended for Marquise Walker. Coming up Tuesday night on ABC, it's the national championship. The Seminoles looking to give Bobby Bowden his first undefeated season and a second national crown, but will Michael Vick's Hokies upset the Noles? We'll find out. Number 1, Florida State. Number 2, Virginia Tech. All part of Super January on ABC, home of the Bowl Championship Series. The Nokia Sugar Bowl has gone interactive with ABC's Enhanced TV. Get real-time stats and more while you watch the game. Lock on to ESPN.com or ABC.com Tuesday night for the national title game. Second and 10 here. Handoff inside at Thomas. Broke the tackle. Out across the 30 to about the 32-yard line. Jared Johnson made the stop as Anthony Thomas got 7. This is what he does best, Bob.
It does. Inside running, and this is where Michigan should stay. There's too much speed from Alabama. This is the longest run of the night. Before this, there had been the fake punt that Ian Gold, the linebacker, ran out of punt formation for 6 yards.
So a third down and three for Michigan. They've got three wideouts to the top of your screen. Brady from the shotgun. Wants to throw back the other way. Does the screen to Thomas with a blocker in front. And a late flag flies in that might take away a first down. Gerald Dixon made the tackle. Flag flew from way out in the secondary. And it is a holding call that will take away a first down, Michigan.
Yep. And it was a good call. Johnson, Diallo Johnson, just came back and blocked in the back.
Illegal block in the back. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Still third down.
Boy, penalties have absolutely killed Michigan. Whoops, that is holding.
This is the foul right there. You can't do anything about it. You want to help, but you can't do anything about it. The only thing you can do is make it worse, so you just back off.
You could have called him for 25 yards on that one. Brings up third down and eight. Brady, delayed blitz coming, fires across the middle, and right there to meet Marcus Knight is Marcus Spencer. So Alabama's defense does its job.
One of Michigan's faster players being covered by a safety. I think they're matching up very nicely. The defensive coordinator, Ellis Johnson, says, I like the way we match up. Skill-wise, our defensive backs on their receivers, and it's showing here tonight.
Freddie Millins rubbing his hands together back near his own 30-yard line, waiting Epstein's punt. Millins is going to have a chance. Freddie from the 31. Slipped one tackle, cut outside, got the corner. Freddie Millins down the sideline, knocked out of bounds, and a penalty marker flies into the fray in the Alabama bench. Epstein's the guy that knocked him out of bounds. Might have been a little bit late.
For those of you who may not know, Freddie Millins is a wide receiver, sophomore, who was a high school quarterback that does just about everything. He's got the speed to run back punts. He just runs around people. They've got him contained. He just outruns three or four Michigan players around the end.
And when he got to that corner, it looked very reminiscent of that long one he ripped off in the SEC championship game. You don't think he's going to get there, and all of a sudden, zoop, he's down the sideline. So a 24-yard punt return, a penalty on top of it. Alabama in front and with the football when we come back.
Your website's going to be set up like an MNDS gigabyte.
A website should be orderly.
I will give you art.
This is your webpage, baby.
Making website is like making good jam.
Developed with the highest in technology.
Got a hard drive.
Who wants some? Who wants some? Look at the kid.
Who designs your website is up to you. Hooking it up and delivering the goods, leave that up to us.
But of course, you'll ship everything.
FedEx.
Like a FedEx plane.
FedEx. Be absolutely sure.
Hey, neighbor. Can I borrow some ice?
Yeah, sure. Hold this.
Yep. Thanks. Got any sugar? Toothbrush? Hair dryer?
With more barbecue and cheddar flavor you can see, more you can taste on every chip and every bite. New Ruffles Flavor Rush potato chips keep you coming back for more.
Whoa, cool.
Cool sight?
Cool sight?
Who says cool?
Who says cool?
Cool what?
Cool. What's it cool?
Boltsmith.com.
Boltsmith.com?
Insurance.
Cool insurance?
Over 300 companies.
I'm hot for this.
Instant is good.
And the best quote is?
Graphics are totally lame.
Yeah, but the quotes will blow you away.
Quotesmith.com. Have you ever said
cool
to insurance?
I have the goosebumps.
There will be a next one. One who changes the game by control, by speed, by power. The NHL on ABC. You're watching ABC Sports coverage of the FedEx Orange Bowl.
Alabama leading by a touchdown earlier. We asked you our Aflac trivia question. The three players from either Michigan or Alabama to be named Super Bowl Most Valuable Player. Bart Starr, a couple of national championships with Green Bay, Joe Namath in Super Bowl III and Desmond Howard of Michigan in Super Bowl 31. Three great players, one still active, two Hall of Famers, and now Alabama with a touchdown lead. Their best starting field position of the ball game at the Michigan 31-yard line. Zhao back in at quarterback. Shaun Alexander has the only score of the night. He's the tailback in the eye. Zhao with a play fake, going to loft one for Bowens, and he made the catch. Inside the 10, down to the 9-yard line. 22-yard pass play.
I'm impressed with the play callings. Charlie Stubbs, the quarterback coach, he just had a series where it was all running, and he took the ball down the field. Now he fakes it to Shaun Alexander and gets the ball in play action down the field.
Best delivery of the night by Zhao, and it's first and goal, Alabama, at the Michigan 9-yard line.
He's staying one step ahead of the posse, as they say. Very good play calling, very good self-scouting.
The give to Shaun Alexander, heading for the quarter, and he's brought down by Gold before he got to the 5-yard line. So it's going to bring up second down and goal. Well, one of the Super Bowl MVPs who played for Alabama has joined us in the booth. Joe Willie Namath. Good to see you, Joe.
Roll Tide.
Roll Tide. They are right now.
Hey, Bob, first of all, Billy Neighbors sends his love.
Uh-huh.
You know, Billy is sitting over here, and Billy was a lineman for Bob that helped protect him with the Dolphins early on. He wanted to make sure I said hi to you, buddy.
We were talking about the great Alabama offensive linemen like Samuels and John Hanna and Dwight Stevenson. And I said, what about Billy Neighbors? You know, Billy.
Shaun Alexander walks in. Touchdown, Alabama. This one from 6 yards out.
I knew I could bring him luck.
All you had to do is put a headset on. Shaun Alexander goes in standing up. Alabama leading 13-0 now. Well, that battle of field position and the exchange of punts in the first quarter finally goes Alabama's way as they grind it out. And Zhao with a give, some good blocking up front.
Cuthbert, 72. Hogan, 74. Give some credit to that offensive line to open those holes.
Blutner for the extra point. He's got it up and good. And the tide starting to roll, as Joe said. 14-0, Alabama in this 2000 edition of the FedEx Orange Bowl, the 66th Orange Bowl. But let's take you back. President Kennedy, part of 73,000 on hand for the 63 Orange Bowl. Leroy Jordan had quite a game. Tried 31 tackles. But there was a little bit of offense in that game, too. Number 12, back to throw. I think this is Richard Williamson on the other end. It's a touchdown, Alabama. And Joe Namath takes him to victory offensively. Remember that one?
I remember it. And, you know, at the time, I didn't know how important Coach Bryant really was to our lives, you know,
right,
to the players that really served under Coach Bryant. And over the years, I've just grown to respect the tradition at Alabama and what the people feel about Alabama football.
Best memories of Alabama and Coach Bryant?
Winning.
Yeah.
Winning, number one. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And being fair. You know, Coach Bryant was the kind of guy that didn't ask you to do anything that he wouldn't try to do or that he didn't think was honest and fair. He was just a hard working, hey, get your nose to it, buddy, and do it. And he was, you only learn to love Coach Bryant after you've been there for a while, after you get to know him.
Discipline?
Discipline.
Sounds like discipline.
Discipline so much, Bob, it almost, you know, ran me off, ran a bunch of us off so many times.
I heard he had somebody at the bus station, so you couldn't get out of town.
Well, he wouldn't let me go home my sophomore year, but from my freshman to sophomore year, he ended up getting me a job at the paper mill to keep me there. But, you know, Leroy Jordan, you mentioned Billy Neighbors, we talked about the tradition. Of course, Michigan. Of course, your son, you know, Brian, did a great job there, and he's doing a heck of a job. And this is what it's about for all of us that have been to universities, sharing the camaraderie and the memories that we have together.
Drew Henson, in at quarterback for Michigan, completes the pass, but a very short game. Joe, you know, talking about the tradition, the kids around Alabama felt that from you. You had a chance to talk to at practice this week.
You know what? Yeah, it's clumsy to be out there talking to these guys because, you know, they hear things all the time, and it's kind of overwhelming to a degree, but then you realize that, hey, listen, you know, we're a part of it. I'm a part of it, and being out there with the team, with the coaching staff, seeing what Mike Dubose did this year with this team, with very difficult circumstances, to overcome some things and to rally the troops around him, has just been wonderful for all of us. And then Mal Moore, our new athletic director, was a teammate of mine. Yeah. And he's old quarterback, too. Uh-huh. So you know things are going to be fine there. But
it's going to be all right if he was a quarterback, right?
Yeah, okay. We took many walks around the block with Coach Bryant. And, he spoke to Mal, myself, and we listened.
Yeah. Here's Henson from the shotgun now with four wideouts for Michigan. On third and 10, he steps up in the pocket. Now he's going to take off with it. Diving forward, looks like he's about a yard shy of a Michigan first down as they trail here with just over 5 minutes remaining in the second quarter by two touchdowns.
I think it's a good move by Lloyd Carr. They're not moving offensively to get Drew Henson in the ballgame. See if it changes the tempo a little bit. He can run a little bit better than Tom Brady, but they're still going to have to punt the football.
Michigan held without a first down five times in their six possessions. Epstein's probably sick of kicking this football, and he's got Millens waiting on the other end again. High kick. Freddie's going to have to call for a fair catch this time, and will, back near the 20-yard line. 44-yard kick. Alabama leading 14-0. They have it when we come back.
Up and never let you down.
It's a 5 or 6!
Make it a Bud Light.
That's a 4. That's
definitely a B.
4, maybe an F.
AT&T 00 Info, how can I help you?
I need the phone number of Petey's dog grooming. Or is it Punky's? I'm not exactly sure the name.
Now you can get information even if you don't have all the information. AT&T customers, dial 00. You don't need the exact name.
Found it. Dog grooming.
Dial 00 for any local or long distance number anywhere. Even Yellow Page listings.
Oh, oh, it's magic. You know.
Number one Florida State takes on number two Virginia Tech for the national championship. The Nokia Sugar Bowl, Tuesday.
With Lynn Swann and Bob Greasy and Joe Namath, Brad Nessler back with you. The FedEx Orange Bowl where Alabama leads by two touchdowns, and they start from their own 20-yard line. Tyler Watts back in at quarterback. He's done a nice job scrambling around tonight. Shaun Alexander's been the workhorse with two touchdowns on the ground. Bowens in motion. Here's a toss sweep. Shaun Alexander follows his blockers. Only got about 2 yards. Let's take you back to a great moment with not only a great quarterback, but a great sportscaster. Here's black and white Jim McKay and Joe Namath. Take a look.
Were you at all jittery or nervous when you first started the ball game?
Well, you always are in a big game. You got a team out there working with you like the rest of the guys from Alabama. A real good team. You don't have to worry too much about it.
Who's going to win Southeastern Conference next year, Joe?
Well, I hope we do.
Alabama, huh? Congratulations to you again.
The skinny kid with good knees. You had good knees on that time. Didn't you?
That's wonderful. You know, really, that is wonderful.
Do you remember scrambling around back at those early days of your life?
You know what? I scrambled almost as much as you did. And we did do our share of scrambling
when
we could.
In the early days of the old AFL.
Yeah.
We were talking with you off the air about how many Orange Bowls you were in, and there was a great one against Texas, too. You still thought you were in Nobis, hit you in the goal line.
Forget about Nobis. You know, he was great. And people say, hey, Joe, didn't you score on that play? I said, well, I crossed the goal line, but I didn't score, you know.
First down, and 19, Alexander running back there and knocked out of bounds. No gain on the play. Well, Bob Greasy and Joe Namath squared off a few times, too. They did against their respective defenses anyway. And there's the records.
Hey, wait a minute. I don't want to look at any numbers or any records, but one thing I do know, Mr. Greasy here did everything anybody could ever dream about doing on the football field.
Oh, bull.
And you know what? It's not bull. It's a fact. And your teammates and everybody in the game appreciate it. See, Bob... You know Bob. He's understated and all that stuff.
Yes, he is, right.
But when you have a football team, you want Bob Greasy as your quarterback.
No, he'll try to rip your head off.
Sure, he was gifted with Paul Warfield and Larry Zonka. He had them in Blake Stevenson.
How would you like to be playing for Alabama with all these five wide receivers?
You know what Coach Bryant once told me? We're getting ready to play Tulane in 62, and Coach Bryant said, Joe, I want you to throw that ball more than you've ever dreamt of throwing it in your life. Okay. Son, I don't care if you throw it 20 times. Yeah. I want you to throw it.
Well,
20 times. It seems like, my gosh, 20 times.
Folks, maybe the two greatest number 12s ever to play quarterback. Joe, it's great to see you. Thanks for joining us. We'll let you go enjoy the ball game.
I'm not leaving.
He's not leaving. He's staying here. All right, we got 4:06 left in the half. We're going to go to New Orleans. John and Terry standing by with an update for us. Guys.
All right, guys, Joe Namath won't leave. We've got Frank Beamer. We hope he won't leave. He's going to join us at halftime. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Great to be with you in the beautiful night in New Orleans.
I'm looking forward to asking you some strategy. Don't want you to reveal anything, but a nice little strategy about the game.
That's all coming up on the National Car Rental Halftime Report. Stick around. More from Frank Beamer and Terry Bowden in a moment. Right now, though, let's go back to our threesome in Miami.
Down out to the 33-yard line.
Take a look from behind the quarterback to the left side. Right, nice view from behind the quarterback, what he sees. And Alexander does a nice job of catching the ball. Take a look at Renus, number 58. He was the key coming in for the Alabama offensive line. Takes two guys to block him there, but Alabama moves out away from the shadow of their own end zone.
Every time somebody gets something going positive, there's a penalty going negative.
Well, that may have been a hold because it looked like one of the linemen had the Renus wrapped up.
So instead of being a first down out near the 35, the line of scrimmage is the 4-yard line. And this is a danger zone now. Alabama doesn't want to make a mistake with 4 minutes left in the half down this close to their own goal line.
What a delightful man, Joe Namath, huh?
Well, that was kind of special having both you guys together. Couple Hall of Famers, not a bad night. Second down, 25. Give to McClintock, the fullback. And he's only going to get to about the 5, maybe the 6. James Hall, and now a fired up Michigan defense thanks to that penalty.
There's a late flag.
Boy, I guess. 10 seconds after the play was over, that one flies in. Officials from the Pac-10 having a little conference here. Want to add our congratulations to Wisconsin for their Rose Bowl win right before our game. Here's a call.
Dead ball, personal foul on the offense. Dead ball, personal foul on the defense. Those fouls canceled. Down remains the same.
So that one's a wash, and it's still third down from the 6-yard line. Mike DeBose would like to try to pick up the first down or at least give his punter a little bit of room to work.
Well, Michigan defensively is going to have to do something to get the offense a kickstart here
right, because
they haven't done anything the entire first half.
Third down at 25. There's been too many of these plays for both teams tonight. They're just going to run it up the middle. Alexander broke the first wave, got out to the 14. Boy, he looks quick tonight. 9-yard pickup, and they did get their punter some room to work. 82 yards for Shaun Alexander in the first half.
And that's just rushing. Of course, that long pass that he just caught was called back with the holding.
Patrick Morgan will punt from his own end zone. Diallo Johnson waiting on it. He should get good field position out of this. High kick hit it a mile in the air. Johnson with a fair catch now has to run up on it. And I think they didn't give him the 2 yards necessary. The flag flies in. He made the catch anyway. Herschel Bolden got down there and got a little too close.
Yeah, they're going to get the ball in positive field position. This will be the second time this half that they've gotten the ball in Alabama field position. The first time, they didn't do anything. In fact, they backed up about 30 yards.
Yeah, they started at the 42 and ended up back at about their own 23. They don't want to do that here and blow a chance to score before halftime. And here you see Bolden come down. You got to give that guy 2 yards, and he's not even giving him 2 feet.
You see that a lot on short punts, where the flyers on the outside expect the ball to be deeper. Michigan, 23 plays offense in the first half, only 52 yards of total offense.
Brady back in at quarterback now at the 44-yard line. So a golden opportunity with 2:36 remaining in the half. And Michigan's got 2 timeouts remaining. Brady fires complete. Down to about the 37.
I think this is what Michigan has to do. Open it up, start throwing the ball to the outside and down the field.
Walker made the catch. Dixon made the stop. This is the deepest penetration now by Michigan tonight.
Number four against number four, Walker and Dixon.
Adam Cox helped out on the tackle. A second down and two. A pickup of 8 on the pass play. Anthony Thomas hasn't gotten much going tonight from the Michigan backfield. He'll get the call here. And Alabama's there to meet him. No gain on the play again. Cornelius Griffin down low and Salim Rashid cleaned up. And you see Rashid shaking his head.
Yeah. That graphic we mentioned a little earlier, held without a first down on 5 of 6 possessions. Great field position here.
They want to get some points before halftime. Third down and 2. We're down to 1:25. Brady fires. He's got the same receiver and the same play. Walker with the first down.
Walker probably has the best running ability after he catches the ball of all the receivers for Michigan.
Ellis Johnson said, I think he's the best with the ball in his hands. And he got enough there to get a first down up to 30. Out of the shotgun. Out of under 1:15. Brady going to fire the other way this time. Complete, but a very short gain and a nice open field tackle by Milo Lewis. Johnson with the catch and hit immediately.
There you are out here. He's just throwing the ball out here. It's too long a throw. Watch the corner. He sees the ball coming out. If it would have gotten there quicker, he could have maybe broke a tackle. But by the time the ball gets out there, Lewis does a nice job of getting up and making the play.
Yeah, that's good corner play right there. It'll be a second down at about 7 as Brady took a timeout. Talking with the quarterback coach Parrish over there on the sideline. Now Brady on the night, 11 of 14, but only 50 yards as we check in with Swanee on the sideline.
Well, Brad, one of the things I'm noticing in this ball game is the fact that one of the reasons Michigan can't get the ball downfield is they just don't have the time to do it. Kenny King, number 55, has been applying pressure all night long. So the cornerbacks are sitting back now, knowing that they can't get the ball deep, and they're starting to jump those short passes. And I fear for Michigan that if they continue those short passes with the cornerback setting back, it's just a matter of time. Most cornerbacks are going to time it, come up, and try and pick one of those off, take a chance.
You talk about short plays, Swanee. The longest play of the night is 9 yards so far tonight for Michigan.
Well, this is where he's throwing the ball behind the line. That's some screen passes and nothing over 15 yards downfield. And maybe that's the problem. Maybe they need to throw it down the field. The other problem is Alabama has completely shut down the running game.
Yep.
So there's no play action involved anymore, and Alabama is just playing pass on every down.
David Terrell, normally a big threat at wide receiver, came in having caught 61 passes for Michigan this year, and he's been a non-entity as well on offense tonight for Lloyd Carr. We're a minute and four from halftime. We'll be heading down to New Orleans. John and Terry will be with Frank Beamer, the head coach of the number two team in the country. A national halftime report, 64 seconds away, and also Gladys Knight will perform here in Miami, and we're looking forward to that. Brady, plenty of time. Now he's going deep to Terrell, touchdown!
There you go.
27 yards, they finally hooked up.
They hadn't thrown downfield all night, as we just showed you in that graphic.
Number one is in the end zone, and now the Michigan fans have something to cheer. Epstein for the point after to try to cut the lead to seven. He's got it up and good. Michigan needed points before halftime, Bob, and they got it.
So the defense set it up, and this is where Brady is looking down here in the middle of the field. The two safeties will split, and Terrell over here on this side is going to get into that circle in the center of the field. Right there, he has the man beat, and here's all the room to the middle of the field. Nice pitch and catch.
Nice time to scan and then deliver.
And Terrell has been indicating to the sideline all during the course of the ball game that he's been open and they want to get the ball to him. Unfortunately for him, they weren't able to get the ball to him much earlier in this ball game because of the kind of pressure that Brady was under. This time, Brady gets a protection. Terrell moves downfield, gets great position on the back, screens him off. Excellent pass and catch.
David had one catch for 3 yards before that one. Good for 27 yards and a touchdown.
Sounds like a wide receiver, doesn't
it? Yeah, give me the ball.
I'm getting open, just give me the ball.
Well, Brady's numbers look significantly better after that last delivery.
Well, that's what they needed to do, is get the ball down the field to make the defensive backs for Alabama respect the deep throw.
44-yard scoring drive, 27 of it. The reception by David Terrell for the touchdown. And Brady, for him, his 17th scoring toss of the season. Freddie Millins says, get it in my hands now.
Mm-hmm.
I'll do something before halftime.
Let me show you what I can do.
Epstein's got it teed up for Michigan. 14-7 Alabama now. As soon as Joe Namath left the booth, Michigan scored.
Very good, partner. And as soon as they came in, they started to score.
Yep. Epstein, a line drive, Millins, over the shoulder catch, nice grab at the two. Now he heads back the other way. And he got across the 20 anyway, out to about the 22-yard line. First half game summary of this one. You knew Shaun Alexander was going to be involved. His first score, 5 yards, barely touched. His second score, 6 yards, untouched. 14-0 until moments ago. Brady, the Terrell, touchdown Michigan. And it's 14-7. That's where we stand. Shaun Alexander's been the offensive star so far. There's his numbers.
As advertised, we talked about him early, and he's having a good night in the first half.
51 seconds till halftime now, and Alabama with the ball at its own 42-yard line. They're going to give it to him again. Alexander all wrapped up, only about a 2-yard gain. Well, if you want to join ABC Sports in Atlanta for the Super Bowl, we've got an idea for you. Watch Monday Night Football coming up this Monday for all the details. That's the 49er-Falcon game this Monday night. But remember, you got to watch to win. Andrew Zau back in at quarterback.
Michigan is a come-from-behind team. They have come from behind several times this year. In fact, 9 of their 11 games were very close, within 7 points.
Yep.
So they're used to playing in tight games.
They won 7 of those games that they were behind of the 11.
Mm-hmm.
And let's see, the first half is going to come to a close on that carry. And it's been a Shaun Alexander half. We showed you his numbers. He's accounted for both of Alabama's touchdowns. And the leading coach, Mike DeBose with Lynn Swan. Mike.
Coach DeBose, a scoreless first quarter, but that second quarter, your offense opened up. What happened in the second quarter? What did you see to open up the offense?
Well, we tried some things early, trying to see how Michigan would align a different personnel group and different types of movement, and we came back and had a feel for what they might do. And then
you just keep expecting could light the scoreboard up at any minute.
His one punt return set up the second Alabama touchdown.
Aiden Epstein's been a busy punter for the most part, a kicker as well. And he is set to start the third quarter from Miami. Here we go. And it will be Freddie Millins from the one. Across the 20, popped pretty good. A penalty marker flies in. Probably an illegal block on the kick return, which would take away decent field position by Alabama. And as they check the penalty, Lynn Swan caught up with Lloyd Carr, the Michigan head coach, just moments ago.
Lloyd, let's first talk about your defense and how you guys can stop that offensive line for Alabama and Shaun Alexander.
Well, I think the first thing we have to do, Lynn, is we've got to be able to throw the football better. We obviously are having a hard time running it, but the most disappointing thing is the number of penalties we've stopped ourselves, and we're going to have to play our best half of football. Alexander's doing a great job, but we're in this ball game.
Well, Lloyd's not going to like the first penalty of the third quarter. Went against his team after that kick return, so it's all the way out to the 40-yard line.
I'm sure that's one of the things he preached about at halftime was the number of penalties.
That's got to drive you crazy. One play into the third quarter, he's got more headaches, and Alabama with a lead and the ball all the way out to the 40. And now Rob Reynolds just lets the center have it. Paul Hogan, who's a good one. Arenas, the captain, the senior, 290-pounder out of Highland, Michigan.
An All-American, a four-time academic All-Big Ten.
Offside on the defense.
We haven't called his name much tonight.
Penalty, still first down.
They handled him pretty well in the first half. Take a look. Number 58, Arenas. Single block right there by Hogan. Arenas was a wrestler, so he's used to getting into some scuffles.
Each team has eight penalties tonight.
Arenas does the dirty work.
Does he ever. There comes another flag. And even the fans starting to boo a little bit here. They're sick of flag football.
It's getting a little sloppy.
Dead ball. False start.
So the five they got, they gave back.
5 yards. Still first down.
It goes back to the original line of scrimmage, so first and 10. Our Morgan Stanley Dean Witter first half statistics. The total yardage there, 156.
Not much.
Not much.
If you like offense, 96 yards for Michigan in the first half is not good. 10 total first downs, and
look at those third down.
Third down conversions. Not good at all.
2 for 13 between the two teams. First and 10 back at the original line of scrimmage. Carter in motion. They fake the handoff pitch to Alexander. It's a fumble. And Michigan's got it. Nope, still squirting out of there. And it goes out of bounds. Michigan had two cracks at it, and the ball just kept coming out of there like a bar of soap.
It looked like Whitley had it for long enough at first, and then the ball came out.
And it finally goes out of bounds way back at the 21-yard line.
Here's another look. This drives coaches nuts, both on offense for Alabama and now defensively. They're just screaming, just get on it. No, he never had it.
Nope.
Whitley never had it.
And Alexander scooped it. Alabama got another late shot right there, and it was not to be.
And yes, they do have drills defensively on recovering ball. They do it every day in practice.
Second and 29 now. They need to get to the midfield stripe for a first down. Alexander dropped in the backfield. Nice play by Dahomey Jones. But Shaun Alexander in the first half was the offense for Alabama.
Kind of spread it out. He ran to the left as much as to the right. Let's get the breakdown on him. Total 84 yards in the first half. Five rushes, 48 yards. Six rushes up the middle. And four rushes to the right, and that's where he got the two touchdowns.
Right. One of 5 yards and one of six. Now it's third and 31. Alexander's out of there as they go to the four wide out. set up for Andrew Zhao. Zhao sets and going deep. Got a man out there. Any penalty flags? They got tangled up a little bit. Jason McCadley. And a flag down.
No flag.
No flag down.
No flag. But I like the call, Brad. Go ahead and take a shot. Throw it down the field. Exactly what you were looking for and I was looking for was the possibility of an interference or a holding, which is an automatic first down.
And now Patrick Morgan's got a punt. They had great starting field position at the 40. And they end up snapping in this one at the 19. Bringing some heat. He got the punt away, and it's a dandy.
That was a legitimate try to block.
Johnson fields it. Got by the first man, but not the second. And after the 40, maybe the 41-yard line. Michigan with the ball back. They trail by a touchdown when we return.
Want to upgrade your workout for the new millennium? Right now, during the best time to buy, get 0% financing till July 2000 on all treadmills priced $599 and above when you use your Sears card. Take this foldable ProForm EKG treadmill featuring power incline. It's only $599.99. You save $200. Sears, the good life at a great price. Guaranteed. Sears is the proud sponsor of the BCS and the Sears National Champion Football Trophy.
What if your car knew you, anticipated your needs, and then reacted to meet them? What if it could adjust to how long your legs are? What if it could help protect you in an accident, with sensors that know where your seat's positioned and the severity of the crash, so the front airbags can react to you? It's time to stop wondering what if. Introducing the new 2000 Ford Taurus with the advanced personal safety system.
Sooner or later, you're going to quit smoking. So consider this. A quit date this good won't come along for another 1,000 years. Don't waste it. Quit with Nicoderm CQ. CQ's got the 3 gradual steps, and hundreds of thousands of smokers have already quit with it. Wasn't one millennium smoking enough? Start the next one with Nicoderm CQ. The power to calm, the power to comfort, the power to help you quit.
I need love, love to ease my mind. I need to find someone to call mine. Mama must say,
together in love. Now there's a whole new way to snack and kick back. Introducing single-serving Tostito snack kits. Just be sure you pick the right time to eat them. Dig in, kick back, Tostitos.
Arizona Angels coming to bat in the first.
Think they've shocked you before? You won't believe the new surprises they've got coming in the new year. An all-new practice returns ABC Sunday, January 9th.
Alabama by a touchdown. Michigan with a first down at its own 41-yard line. Brady at quarterback. Alabama thought about a blitz. They back out of it. Brady with a play fake. Tosses it out to his fullback. Shea fumble out of bounds.
Well, both offenses have had fumbles that have gone out of bounds on the first possession, second half.
That one's going to gain him a little bit of yardage as Marcus Spencer put the hit on it.
Alabama defense, first half, they were there. They had the answer for everything. Kenny King, heat on the quarterback. Johnson. Michigan had less than 100 yards total offense first half.
Alabama's rush defense did their job. Number 2 in the country, as we said earlier, and they're showing why. Pickup of only 2 on that pass play. Play action, Brady, look out! He got away from one, got away from another, and threw it downfield and got rid of it. Boy, that was a nifty bit of footwork by Tom Brady, who didn't go down.
Well, this was going to be a play action pass, and Rasheed blitzing. You don't want to have a play action pass on a blitz. They had a receiver down the field, single coverage. He had a shot at him, but with the blitz and Rasheed in there, it just blew the whole thing right up.
Brady's dance step saved Michigan about 10 yards.
Yeah. If you're a quarterback at the line of scrimmage and you have that play called, you like to get out of it if you read a blitz.
Third down and 8. Shea, the fullback in motion, and Brady from the gun. Here comes a blitz from the corner. He goes that way, and he's got Terrell in the open field. David Terrell inside the 20. Michigan. Touchdown. Yards, Brady to Terrell, and that's been the hookup twice for Michigan. Alabama blitzes, you leave single coverage. Here goes the blitz right here. You got single coverage on the outside, man-to-man coverage. Brady does a nice job of finding a slot, buying some time, and a poor tackle on the outside by Lewis.
And that's a career-long reception for Terrell. A point away from tying it up. Epstein does. Just like that, Boyd Carr told Lynn Swann, we're going to have to open up the offense. They did. They scored a 57-yard touchdown, and we are dead even in Miami. Tied at 14.
Always value the individual above all else. Comes the most individual way yet of achieving success. Presenting iChoice from Morgan Stanley Dean Witter. A whole new level of personal service that lets you achieve your success your way. How do you measure success? Stanley Dean Witter. We measure success one investor at a time.
To me, this isn't a hobby or even a sport. It's an obsession. So if I can't get out to this exact spot at this exact time of year, I may as well be bowling.
Get out there, an expedition from your Ford Outfitter. Outfitting you with the most far-reaching sport utilities on earth. Ford Outfitters, no boundaries.
The FedEx Orange Bowl. This ABC Sports exclusive brought to you by FedEx. FedEx, be absolutely sure. Morgan Stanley Dean Witter. We measure success one investor at a time. Nicoderm CQ, the power to calm, the power to comfort, the power to help you quit. And Ford, the latest innovations, the greatest tradition.
That's where most of our crew spent last night, South Beach. Some of us behaved ourselves.
Uh-huh.
The sights and sounds of South Beach, nothing like it.
I understand you went out on the beach.
I was on the beach.
Huh?
I wasn't in a traffic jam like that last night. Tied at 14 now. Epstein's kick high and short. Richards going to field this one at the 12-yard line. Out to the 20. Got away. Nice return by Richard out to the 27-yard line. Epstein's the guy that knocked him out of bounds.
Well, Brad, Mike DeBoer, the offensive coordinator for Michigan, said the first half we were concerned about protecting the quarterback. He felt like they got it fixed in the second quarter, so he said we're going to open it up. And here's a great example. They get the good blocking. They get the ball to David Turner. Watch Marcus Knight, 85. Here's a heads-up play by not making a block, not getting the clip. Great job just letting the guy go. And keep in mind, this guy was a young man from Alabama who went to Michigan.
Boy, that takes some guts. And he's playing in his second game against the team from his native states. Watts got away from one. Sets, fires back across the field. Alexander across the 40. And it's a first down, Alabama. Pickup of 13.
Things are starting to pick up a little bit. I think both offenses now know what they can do and what they can't do against these dominant defenses. They'll play action. Watts does a great job getting away from Hall. This was designed to go the whole way, the throwback to the halfback after you fake to him.
Watts is 3 for 3, Bob, now, including that toss.
He's alternated series with Bazal. The entire game, each quarterback has a touchdown.
Again, the quick snap count, play action. He rolls and throws and finds Freddie Millins. And a nice open field tackle, because that guy can always take off on you. Only a pickup of about 4. Coming up Tuesday night on ABC, it's the national championship. The Seminoles of Bobby Bowden. Can they stay undefeated and win another national title, or will the Hokies of Virginia Tech pull an upset? It's all part of Super January on ABC, home of the Bowl Championship Series. And the Nokia Sugar Bowl has gone interactive with ABC's Enhanced TV. Get real-time stats and more while you watch the game. Log on to ESPN.com or ABC.com Tuesday night. Brent and Gary and Swatty and Jack will bring you all the action of the national championship.
Looking forward to seeing that one.
2nd and 6. Antonio Carter in motion from the Bama backfield. And they're going to get him the ball. And he's out near midfield, about a yard shy of a first down. Cato June made the tackle. It's going to bring up 3rd down, a long yard.
You know, that national championship game on Tuesday night, the BCS, everybody was writing about it, criticizing it. You know, it's worked the last 2 years.
Right.
You know, you got the right two teams in the game, and it should be a heck of a ball game.
Alabama fans are thinking that they might have a crack at being in the big game next year, and obviously so is Michigan. Two clubs here, one looking for its 11th win, one looking for its 10th. And here's Shaun Alexander busting it into the secondary. He might take it. Alexander is gone. Touchdown, Alabama.
Is he special or what?
50 yards of special on that one. Oh, boy, now we got something working here. Alabama back in front.
He broke 3 or 4 tackles and then just outran the fastest guys on the defense. Power and speed.
132 yards, 50 yards, the last gallop. Pflugner for the extra point. And he's got it up and through. 8th 100-yard game this year for that young man. 17 carries, 132 yards. That one, his 3rd touchdown of the night. It's Alabama 21, Michigan 14.
What if your car knew you, anticipated your needs, and then reacted to meet them? What if it could adjust to how long your legs are? What if it could help protect you in an accident? With sensors that know where your seat is positioned and the severity of the crash, so the front airbags react to you. What if it went even further? Wouldn't that make sense? What if it could prevent potential problems or light the road better at night? What if its testing exceeded anything the real world can dish out? Is that possible? What if it made genius obvious and brilliance accessible? It's time to stop wondering what if. Introducing the new 2000 Ford Taurus.
Get the good life now at Sears during the best time to buy. For example, save $120 on this Kenmore washer and dryer pair and get free delivery. Sears, proud sponsor of the Bowl Championship Series and the Sears National Champion Football Trophy.
Combat Rangers. They're rough, they're tough, they're battle-tested.
Can I see a jet?
Combat Rangers.
Incoming! Cover me!
They're lean, mean fighting machines.
No!
When there's a battle to be won, Combat Rangers get the job done.
Combat Rangers, making backyards safe for democracy.
Now, tell me why they're wearing dresses.
The commander uniforms didn't arrive from China on time.
That's because you picked the wrong shipping company.
Do you let them know that the whole...
Next time, use the only U.S. Express shipper with direct routes from China, FedEx. Be absolutely sure.
Is that a thong?
Oh, boy. We thought it could double as a holster.
Matching handbag, heels, and night vision tiara sold separately.
This January, the main event is on ABC.
I'm the greatest. I am king of the world.
Muhammad Ali, king of the world. ABC Monday, January 10th.
Bob said it best. He's something special. Shaun Alexander, the SEC Player of the Year, showing why tonight. Another touchdown run against the Michigan defense. He's accounted for all three of the scores tonight and 24 of the 42 this year.
The amazing thing to me, too, is that he sheds those blocks with the arm that he's got the ball in. It doesn't matter to shift the ball over.
Water cross on the kick return from the eight. And he got cut down as he got to the 25. Let's take you back to that last touchdown run again.
It's a beauty. Cuthbert and Hogan. Right there, he's got the ball in the right hand, and all three defenders try to tackle him from that side, and they all slide off.
And then to shed those tacklers, and as you said, just outrun the secondary. That's pretty good combination running. So now let's see if Michigan can answer again. They had tied it up on the long touchdown pass. Brady, 14 of 18 tonight. Two touchdowns to Terrell. And now his offense works from the 25-yard line. Play action. Wants to throw the screen back to the near side of the fullback and does. Oh. And Alabama's seen that too many times.
Well, you can't fake and then throw it. I mean, once you fake, that just pulls everybody over there. And then you go ahead and throw it over there. They've got a running start.
Man, Alabama so fast on defense.
Trying to get the ball to Shea, number 36. He wasn't out where he thought he was supposed to be. If he would have gotten out a little bit further, could have given it to him the first time he faked it at him.
That was Reggie Grimes that dropped Shea in his tracks. Big defensive tackler at a touchdown in the SEC championship game on an interception. Second and 10, some movement. Looked like Chris Zeman came out of his stance.
I think Alabama is finished with blitzing. The last series, they blitzed him one time and sacked
him. Killed him.
The second time they blitzed, they gave up a touchdown.
Dead ball. False start. On the offense. 5 yards. Still
Tom Brady. Going to have to try to bring his Michigan team back again, as he has done so many times this year. As Bob said, sometimes for Michigan, when they got behind in the fourth quarter, it's right where they wanted to be.
Now here's Penn State. He brought him back from that one. Here's Ohio State. He brought him back from that one.
Trying to bring him back again here in the second half. Throws it back to Thomas, and again, all wrapped up by Miguel Merritt. That outside linebacker, senior, out of Hopkinsville, Tennessee's had himself a game.
Yeah, the short stuff is not working. The screens and the crossing stuff, you're better off just staying outside one-on-one with these guys. You're not going to fool the speed of Alabama. They're sitting back in zones. I think that's the best thing for them to do, and not blitz. Michigan's got too much speed on the outside.
And so long yardage again on third down. Third and 17. They've got to get it all the way out to the 35-yard line to pick up a first. They haven't done a good job on third down tonight. Brady, pump fakes, steps up, steps down. Sacked at the 10-yard line. Cornelius Griffin. And Merritt's there to help him.
You shouldn't get sacked with a three-man line in a rush of only three guys.
Griffin tied for the team lead in sacks coming in. And just got another piece of one there.
Three-man line. Brady needs to find an opening to buy some time.
Nice kick. Freddie Millins back pedals to the 38. Straight ahead he goes. Freddie Millins cuts outside. He's got great speed.
He's gone.
At the 40. Forget about it. Millins down the sideline. Alabama touchdown. 62 yards. We said to start the second half, you just expected sometime number 15 would have a statement. I think he just made it.
He broke open the SEC championship game with a run, and he may just have broken this one open too.
62-yard punt return, his second punt return for a touchdown this year. And the extra point is up and good. Michigan now trailing by two touchdowns again. Here's another look.
The further you kick the ball, the more dangerous he is. He looks for red shirts. And he's got a ton of them. Jones, number 19, gets a nice block that springs him.
So electrifying when he gets his hands on the ball in a variety of ways in this Alabama offense. But on special teams, he shows how special he is again.
And Brad, he came to Alabama on the promise that they would open up the offense. He was looking at Alabama, thinking about going to Florida, to some Starkville, Mississippi, and he bought into the promise that Alabama was going to open up the offense. They did, but keep in mind, number 15, by virtue of his talent, has also helped to open up the offense by plays like that.
Well, well said, Swanner. You're right. He was the MVP of the SEC championship game and only caught one pass as a starting wide receiver. It's what he did elsewhere that earned him that honor.
And we haven't seen him at quarterback, I think, maybe one time tonight.
Yep. Well, Bearden's got it teed up.
Big plays. Shaun Alexander's 50-yard run, and then the punt return by Millens is the difference in the second half.
High short kick, fielded at the 15-yard line and brought up the sideline by Kevin Bryant out to about the 27-yard line. Well, we said he's Mr. Versatility. Freddie Millens, to show you some of the things he can do. How about on this end around against Arkansas, then set up and the former high school quarterback to McCadley downfield. Long touchdown. Here he is in that SEC championship game, the play Bob talked about. That play designed to go to the left. Nothing there. Comes back the other way and goes 77 yards for a touchdown. And now he's added another punt return for a score here in this one.
David Palmer reinvented.
Yep. Maybe even a little bit faster.
Yeah.
First down, Michigan. Now they're in a hole at the 28-yard line, trailing by two touchdowns. Brady comes up firing. Just off the fingertips of Terrell. That would have been a big gainer out to midfield. Reggie Miles was there.
But this is what Michigan has to do. This is their best shot of moving the ball and scoring points. Terrell going to run a skinny post.
Just off his fingertips.
Should have caught it.
Yeah, probably.
Should have caught it.
Second down, Michigan. 8:17 remaining in the third quarter. Brady, the quick drop, fires out Terrell. This time he's got him diving out across the 35. He didn't get the first down. He's a couple yards shy. It'll bring up third down and two. Don't forget, tomorrow night, the BCS continues on ABC. Eric Crouch and Big 12 champion and number 3 Nebraska taking on T. Martin and number 5 Tennessee in the Tostitas Fiesta Bowl tomorrow night live, 8 o'clock Eastern, 5 Pacific. All part of Super January on ABC, home of the Bowl Championship Series, and that's what those two young fellows mean to their teams. They're good ones. Join Tim and Dean and Leslie tomorrow night for yet another in the BCS Bowl Series here on ABC. Brady to fire out. And this is complete for a first down. Back to Terrell on the other side. So slowly, Michigan working it down the field. 7 minutes, 33 seconds remaining in the quarter. Tom Brady in his final appearance. The Michigan quarterback, there's what he's done so far tonight.
A lot of short passes behind the line and 15 yards or less. And where they're getting things done is down the field.
Yep, those two over 15 were both touchdowns. To David Terrell, one of 27, one of 57. Brady from the gun, fires short again on a quick out. Nice move over there by Terrell to pick up a little bit of extra yardage out across the 46-yard line. Milo Lewis ran him out. Terrell came in with 61 catches to lead the club in receiving and almost 900 yards through the air as well.
Just a sophomore, he has played defense in 7 of the Michigan 11 games. In fact, he played a lot against Purdue. He played something like 45 snaps on the defensive side.
Second down and 3. Terrell's over 100 yards receiving now. Brady's going deep the other side. Just overshot Marquise Walker.
Like the call. Good coverage. Bailey, number 13, is a nickel back, a dime back that comes in against 3 and 4 wide receivers, and he had good coverage.
Brady looks to the sideline. You saw Henson with the signal of the play. And on the season, the Michigan receivers, there's what they've done. The most yards combined by a Michigan wide receiver duo when you consider some of the great ones, Imani Toomer and Ricky Hayes, who had the previous mark. That's pretty good company. Brady to throw. Down the middle he goes to his fullback, Shea, and he's got a first down at the 40-yard line. Pickup of 14. By the way, Terrell going over 100 yards. That's five 100-yard games this season. That ties the great AC, Anthony Carter, in 82, and Ty Streets in 98.
Aaron Shea is a fullback, you know, coming into this ballgame. He only had 11 rushes for 31 yards, but he came into this ballgame with 31 receptions. He is critical to this offensive team's passing success, Brad.
And they go back to the ground game. Swalia Thomas, who's really been a non-factor on the ground tonight, picks up about a yard. 16 carries is all for 16 yards, rather, on 10 carries for Anthony Thomas.
Yeah, I think Alabama coming in number two in the nation in rushing defense. I think some people question that. Some of the teams that they had played in the SEC doesn't run the ball too well. I think we're seeing a pretty tough run defense here tonight.
Everybody up close for Alabama this time. A second down and eight. They back out of the blitz. Brady fires. Terrell's got another one. Down to the 20. First down, Michigan.
This one he catches.
Right in front of Gerald Dixon, who had decent coverage, but Terrell used his body well, went up and snatched it.
Well, when the quarterback sees one-on-one coverage out here and you're just going to have a skinny post up here, you like that combination. Get deep, throw it to the inside. That's the same thing that Terrell dropped the other side about three or four or five plays earlier.
So Terrell got a first down for Michigan right at the 20-yard line. Brady fires out to him again. Made a move at the 15, the 10. He's in again. Touchdown, Michigan. That's three from Brady to Terrell. And Michigan bounces right back into the game.
Alabama comes back with a blitz. Lewis out there by himself again. He's a good coverage guy, but he needs to work on his tackling.
Yep. Epstein for the point after. Just like that, Michigan back within a touchdown. A lot of football left. A lot of football in that young fella tonight. Shaun Alexander scored three times. David Terrell has scored three times. That one, a 20-yard pass from Brady. His third scoring toss of the evening. 28-21, Alabama.
At Nokia, we've discovered that adjusting the color of your phone can be this easy. With Express On color covers for the Nokia 5100 series wireless phone. Nokia. Connecting people.
It seems that the first rule of business today is to be an e-business. The second rule is to work with a company who pioneered the direct way of using the internet as a business tool. Dell built their business around this direct model, which made them a forerunner in e-business. They provided the equipment we needed to use the internet to establish one-to-one relationships with our customers. With Dell's help, we're breaking down the walls between our ideas and reality.
Be direct. Dell. Dell workstations use Intel Pentium 3 processors.
Tuesday, January 11th at 10, 9 Central.
Remember me?
Blue is back. The season premiere of NYPD Blue, Tuesday, January 11th on ABC.
5:42 remaining in the third quarter. Michigan with a touchdown has cut the lead to a touchdown. 28-21 tied. Brad Nessler, Bob Gracie, Lynn Swan, and Freddie Millens with you from Pro Player Stadium in the 66th FedEx Orange Bowl. And Freddie Millens back waiting on it. The kick coming up from Epstein. Last time they tried to keep it away from him, they kicked it short to Arvin Richard. This time they kick deep, and it will be Freddie Millens. 3 yards in, he's going to have to take a knee. That time Epstein got all of it, which he's done a pretty good job of this year. Let's go back to the touchdown, Bob.
Let's go back, and this is what Brady saw. He sees a linebacker here, a linebacker in the line, and another linebacker there, and he sees his number one receiver one-on-one out here on the outside. Blitz, single coverage, just get it out there, missed tackle. You got your favorite receiver, 61 receptions, as Brad said, coming into the game, 3 touchdowns and counting.
Which ties an Orange Bowl record. There's his numbers. 3 touchdowns. And here's another guy with 3 touchdowns, but he barely got that handoff or pitch, whatever you want to call it. Rob Arenas finally makes a hit, and that one was an ugly-looking play.
I think Andrew Zhao may have gotten stepped on. He just barely got him the ball. There's Arenas. That's exactly what happened. Arenas shoved Hogan back and stepped on Zhao. Blew up the whole thing.
That's a double whammy by Arenas there. He got a good piece of a really good center. Knocked him into the quarterback and then helped out on the tackle.
Arenas, for a guy that doesn't get hardly any sacks and make hardly any tackles, has so much of an impact in a ball game. All the Alabama coaches offensively were talking about him.
And now Zhao has trouble with a snap from center, but he's still got it to Freddie Millens. Millens, oh, what a hit at the 25-yard line by James Whitley. Never saw him coming. That's what you call getting ear hold. Man alive.
And then all the zebras come and talk to him and say, just relax. He says, I want to get a piece of it. Look at this, right out here. It's going to be a quick screen. The first two guys go down and block, and then they say, all right, Freddie. He got away from him once, but he didn't get away from him twice.
Freddie, take the playoff.
Oh, boy.
Third down at 4.
Best thing about Alabama, they got him around for a couple more years. That's He's right. Only a sophomore.
Zhao's had trouble with a couple of the snaps and the shotgun tonight, including that last play. That's Bowens in motion. Zhao in the pocket. Finds an open man, but he dropped the ball. It was Antonio Carter. Would have been a first down. Didn't hold it. And now Alabama has got to give it up. Michigan's defense does its job.
Well, Michigan is used to being in this position, as we've talked about. Being behind, coming from behind. That's not the quarterback's fault. That should have been a first down. Alabama should have been still on the field offensively.
Might have been the best pass Zhao's thrown all night. The guy dropped it.
Look out.
High kick. Johnson with a fair catch will take it just inside his own 40-yard line. And 28-21. Alabama in front. And Michigan got the ball back, Swanee.
Yes, and that means we got to watch out for number one, David Terrell. He has been the workhorse for this offense. He has been unbelievable so far. And keep in mind, he is 6'3", 208 pounds, and a sophomore. He is a formidable target. He has great athletic skills and good balance. And you just cannot go after him thinking, well, I'll just pop him, he'll go down. A lot of hits out here, but you got to wrap this young man up. But he is after it this evening. He wants it badly. Look for him just to keep going right to number one.
Well, you've thrown it at him 10 times, Lynn, and he's caught 8 of them for 144 yards and 3 touchdowns. Brady going to him again. Diving attempt. Couldn't hold that one. The pass thrown well behind him.
Yeah, I think you're right, Swanee. And I always felt like when I had a receiver that was having success and having a big night, that he wanted the ball, and if you got it to him, he would make something happen, and he would get open to allow you to get him the ball.
That's right, Bobby. And you know this young man has got great stamina because, as you pointed out earlier, he played a lot of defense a year, played a big game against Purdue. So he likes this. He likes being the center. He likes having this kind of role in the ballgame.
Michigan down a touchdown with 3:44 left in the third. Trying to change that and tie it up again. Brady to throw. Swings it out to the fullback, Shea. Broke one tackle and backpedals his way out near midfield. Good tough run after the catch. And it's going to bring up third down and short. 3:36 remaining in the third quarter. Tom Brady looks up there at the scoreboard. Both teams would like to be looking at that Sears National Championship trophy, but the teams that are Florida State and Virginia Tech, emblematic of the national championship. That gorgeous piece of hardware is either going to Blacksburg or Tallahassee. And we'll find out Tuesday night. But here at Pro Players Stadium, the 66th Orange Bowl has turned into a dandy. Couldn't have been sloppier in the first quarter. Couldn't have been more fun since. Third and three. Brady fires complete. First down at the 47-yard line. Shaun Thompson, his tight end, catches his first pass of the night.
Well, both teams have told us this week that they're just scouting out the Orange Bowl. They'd like to come back for an encore next year when the championship game of the BCS is here at the Orange Bowl.
Yep. And Mike DeBoe said at the luncheon thing the other day, we'll just accept the invitation to come back next year right now if you don't mind.
Well, I want to tell you, they'd be in the hunt right now.
Yep, they would.
The way they're playing the last five or six ball games.
Brady fires, guess who? Nice move by Terrell. And another move inside the 40.
Is he hot or what? He is feeling it.
He says his favorite Michigan athlete of all time is Anthony Carter. And he's wearing the same number, and he's doing AC proud right now.
Top of your screen. He's going to do a little stop. Get him the ball and some space. Bailey doesn't tackle him, but he got some help from his friends. And that's all Bailey wanted to do, just slow him up.
His numbers getting more and more impressive as the game goes on. Brady drops. Going to fire long for the other wide receiver. Just off the fingertips of Marcus Knight. That was close. Gerald Dixon, the true freshman back there. Knight got his fingers on it and just couldn't quite hold it. Should have caught a kid from Sylacauga, Alabama, wanted to have that one.
Oh, you got that right. There's only one Alabama player on the Michigan team, and it's this one right here. Marcus Knight, perfect throw.
Should have caught him. He said when it came time to sign that national letter of intent, he had two pieces of paper, Alabama and Michigan, and he had to think about it and pray about it. And he said, the morning I signed it, I still wasn't sure. Something just told me Michigan. Here's a crossing pattern to the fullback again, and Shea's in the secondary. And all the way down, he rumbles to the 15-yard line. Swanee said a couple minutes ago he's an integral cog to this offense. He just went 24 yards. First down, Wolverine.
Yeah. He's in the backfield right here. He's going to make a move to the outside and then come back inside. He's like an H-back. A couple years ago, he was a tight end for Michigan. Last year and this year, he's a fullback. Little swing to the outside. Good feet.
Now it's Anthony Thomas straight up the middle.
Now the run works because you've got Alabama back on their heels guarding against the pass that you've hurt them against. Now you come with the run.
Depending on where they spot it, it's going to be first and goal, I think.
It's amazing how the passing game, which we talked about in the Giddell game solutions, opens up the run.
Guys, remember when we sat around the table with the Michigan players? One thing they told us that I was very interested in was the fact that they felt that they could wear down Alabama. They felt that they were in such great shape that during the course of this ball game, if they were able to just pound the ball, go after them, they felt that eventually in the fourth quarter, they could wear this Alabama football team down. Right now, the Alabama defense is not as fast as they were in the first quarter.
Good point. And one of the other things that we said in our game solutions early on is that Alabama defensively wanted to get off the field as soon as they could because they didn't want to be in this situation. This big Michigan offensive line, the big fullback, the big tailback, no, trying to stop them in the fourth quarter.
What is it about this Michigan team? They don't come to play until they get in a hole. They're trying to even that hole off. down to maybe the 2-yard line or the 3 is Anthony Thomas. It's going to be second down and goal. They got the first down just by the tip of the football. And Thomas got him even closer. They're going to put it right at the 3. Michigan's fourth quarter comebacks well documented. We've been talking about it all night.
They did it at Notre Dame. They did it Indiana. And they did it against Penn State. They were down 14 points just a couple of minutes ago. Here in this
now, they're knocking on the Alabama door. Second and goal at the 3. Thompson, the tight end, in motion. The give. No play fake by Brady to the end zone. Incomplete. Bill Seymour, the tight end, had his hands and couldn't hold it. Nice play. Perfect execution, except he just couldn't keep his hands on it.
Saw this play the other day at practice, too. They have several different tight ends. Got a fake. Now he's going to look to the end zone.
So close.
A lot of these catches, Marcus Knight just dropping one earlier. All these balls are balls that could be caught. But this is not pro football. This is
going to make mistakes.
This is college football, student athletes. A little drop some.
Third and goal, Michigan. Trying to tie the game. Thomas, touchdown, Wolverine.
Nice call.
Finally, Anthony Thomas has something to say about this football game. His run got him down to first and goal, and his 4-yarder got him in the end zone.
Nice call. Mike DeBoard, the offensive coordinator, had Alabama sitting back on their heels. Third down, came with a running play.
3-yard touchdown, and now the extra point by Epstein to try to tie it again. And he does. We thought maybe Michigan had put itself in a hole too deep to climb out of. But Anthony Thomas has changed our mind. It's 28-28.
Backus and Hutchinson, Thompson, Shea, the fullback, and the A-train.
And the train just made a stop in the end zone. And for him, another productive season. That is his 17th rushing touchdown of 99/2000. From high atop Pro Players Stadium, this is the 66th FedEx Orange Bowl, and it has turned into a beauty. And Lloyd Carr and Mike DuBose, one trying to win his 10th game for a third straight year in Lloyd Carr. Mike DuBose trying to win number 11. And both trying to win this BCS Bowl game and look ahead to next year to maybe even brighter things. Who knows? They aren't separated by undefeated seasons by much, that's for sure.
And they both know each other very well. They're both defensive coaches. Lloyd Carr was a defensive coordinator at Michigan, went down to Alabama to talk to the staffs and
after Alabama had won its national championship.
Yeah. Yep.
So Epstein, whose legs got to be getting tired, is set to kick. Although the last one, he knocked 4 yards deep and Freddie Millins couldn't return it.
He's back there again.
This kick high and shorter. Richard says it's mine and he'll take it at the 12. That's out across the 25 to about the 26. Cato June made the stop on the special teams. And now let's see if Alabama can put some offense together. Maybe get it back in Shaun Alexander's hands. So Alabama huddles on the sideline as we look down from high above. Our pictures from the Goodyear Blimp Stars and Stripes. 75-year-old tradition for Goodyear Blimps to make appearances at major events. Our beacon in the sky. And down on the turf of Pro Players Stadium, first down Alabama at the 27. Watts, a long handoff to Shaun Alexander, looking for the corner. Got it. Got about 8. Went right into the first down marker over there.
Well, if you just joined us, I need to remind you that the first 6 or 7 offensive possessions were 3 plays and punts. You never believe it. by looking at the score, how well the offenses are doing now.
We had a scoreless first quarter with a whole bunch of penalties.
And a whole bunch of punts.
Yep. Now 44 seconds remaining in the third, and we're tied at 28. Second down and two. Millen's in motion, gets the toss, looking for a block. Waits for that blocker, but still lost yardage. That one never had a chance. Freisinger and Foote got over there to knock him out of bounds.
Millen's coming back from the wide receiver position to take that pitch.
And he's been a big part of the game, but maybe not as much as these two guys in our Nokia player comparison. Terrell, 152 yards receiving and tying an Orange Bowl record with three touchdown catches. And Shaun Alexander, 139 and three, including a 50-yard run. Third and three. And it is Alexander. He's not going to get this first down. Good job defensively. Rob Arenas is on the bottom of that pile. Senior defensive captain.
Arenas in the middle. Doesn't make many tackles. Number 58 right in here. Stands the center up and also tackles the center and the ball carrier.
He's had a heck of a lot more action going on in the second half than he did in the first. We're winding down the third quarter. May not get this punt off. In fact, let's wait and see. We might be kicking the other way. And we will be. Alabama's going to have to give it up to start the fourth quarter, but through three, we're deadlocked at 28. This ABC Sports presentation of the FedEx Orange Bowl will continue after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Your website's going to be set up like an MMDS gigabyte with a rotating geostationary satellite. We feel that both you and your customer will appreciate binary riddles that users love. You know, that's part of the fun. Wait till you guys see this. The technology will be obsolete by the time we leave here today, but that's okay because we'll come back.
Who designs your website is up to you. Hooking it up and delivering the goods, leave that up to us.
Of course, you ship everything FedEx.
FedEx. Be absolutely sure.
In any business, there can be only one priority. At Morgan Stanley Dean Witter, we have never forgotten ours. Not surprisingly, we measure success a little differently.
Sunday, January 9th, the phenomenon is back.
He's $1 million.
Who Wants to Be a Millionaire returns Sunday, January 9th on ABC.
What's small about McDonald's new big extra burger? Nothing but the fries. Just 99 cents every day. That's right, 99 cents every single day. The new big extra with big bold seasoning seared right into our largest all beef patty and topped off with tomatoes, lettuce, pickles, and onions. The new big extra. Big burger, small price. Just 99 cents every day. Come by and get yours now. Only at one place. Did somebody say McDonald's?
Now with Bell South Fast Access Internet Service. Faster downloads. Another solution with Bell South Nova.
All of us at Channel 2
wish you a happy new year.
This is ABC Sports, home of the Bowl Championship Series.
The third game of our ABC triple header today is a beauty going into the fourth quarter. Alabama 28, Michigan 28, the 66th FedEx Orange Bowl starts to four stanza. This is the second straight three and out for Alabama. And they're going to have to punt. Patrick Morgan to kick. Yalo Johnson waiting on the other end for Michigan. End over end, not a good punt. Johnson has a chance to field at the 31. It goes straight ahead for about 10 yards. And good field position for Michigan. They were down by two touchdowns, but that guy's led them back. Now they're looking for the lead when we return.
I want it to be a new way of looking at things.
I want it to be larger than life.
I want it to be a customer magnet.
I want it to be the second industrial revolution.
It should transport me wherever I want to go and take me back to where I came from.
I wanted to level the playing field.
Nortel Networks is building the new high-performance internet to be whatever you want it to be. So tell us, what do you want the internet to be?
A cash cow. Come together right now over me.
It's Super January on ABC. Big 12 champion number 3 Nebraska faces number 5 Tennessee in the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl Sunday.
First offensive play of the fourth quarter coming up, and it's Michigan from its own 40. Tom Brady sidesteps a rush, throws over the middle, got his tight end down inside the 40. Jopru found room down there for 24 yards. First down, Michigan.
There's the tight end right here. He's just going to come down, get lost, and then go to the middle of the field. It helps if you get a tight end, a little stop and go, gets to the middle of the field, can split the safeties. Well-designed play here. Mike DeBoer, the offensive coordinator, doing a nice job.
That's the 8th different receiver Tom Brady's hooked up with tonight. First down at the Alabama 36. And now Anthony Thomas, no gain on that one. Our Tostitos game summary of this one. We've had a lot of stars, but what a third quarter Michigan put together with 21 points. Terrell, a huge part of that. 3 touchdown catches tonight, and they converted 7 of their 8 third downs in that quarter. And Shaun Alexander, 3 touchdowns on the ground tonight. Freddie Millens, the punt return for the touchdown. That's where we stand.
Somebody woke them out of their slumber.
I guess.
As you mentioned, no points in the first quarter.
There's the guy to watch, Terrell. He's to the near side on a 2nd and 10. And now some movement inside. Jared Johnson in across and made contact. Unless he was drawn off, that's going to go against Alabama.
Michigan has had 4 possessions in the second half. They have scored 3 touchdowns.
Contact, offside
on Alabama. 3-5, so it'll be 2nd down and 5 now.
And the only time they didn't score a touchdown, they had to punt. Freddie Millens ran that
That's
one back
right.
for a touchdown.
There's the penalties. Both teams almost in double figures. Alabama, their 10th of the night. School record for them in a category they would just as soon forget.
I think that has a lot to do with coming back after a long layoff. You're just a little sloppy.
A 2nd down and 5 just outside Here the 40. Brady sidesteps a rush, throws deep, and it's caught at the 2-yard line by Marquise Walker. What an adjustment he made in midair.
Michigan has to throw to the outside. That's where they have their big play guys. If they can't run, they can throw the ball outside.
Bob, I'll tell you, that got me excited, watching him go up for that ball. I mean, this is the kind of catch you dream about making, being able to go up in the air, make that kind of catch. Unbelievable.
And he got it down just outside the two. First and goal, Michigan. And now Anthony Thomas and Shea are both behind Brady. Michigan has never led in this football game. They've been down by two touchdowns. And Thomas hit hard. No gain on that play. Alabama trying to dig in and come up with a goal line stand. Their lead very much in jeopardy, or rather the tie game in jeopardy, but they have led throughout this game.
And, you know, sometimes, Lynn, when a guy like David Terrell is making big plays, it kind of ignites the other receivers on the team. And when they get an opportunity, they go up and make good plays too, don't they?
Three tight ends from Michigan. Brady, play action. Going to the end zone. Overshot his intended receiver, but a flag down. Might be a penalty on Marcus Spencer back there in the end zone.
Now that play would have been better called on the first down instead of second down. They were ready for it that time, Alabama.
Penalty marker thrown at Spencer, the safety.
Holding.
Holding
an eligible receiver by the defense on a forward pass beyond the line. Half the distance to the goal. First down.
Big thing there is first down. Instead of being third down, you go back to first down.
Might have been on Miles, not Spencer. At any rate, half the distance to the goal. Another look here. There it is. There's the hold. Yep, it's on Miles, not Spencer. Spencer came over to try to help out, but it was too late. Michigan trying to take the lead. Thomas. Is he in? And now the ball loose. Alabama's got it. Darius Gilbert with a fumble recovery. That's how you stop and come up with a goal line stand, I guess. Come up with a fumble recovery in the end zone.
That's the first turnover of the ball game.
Thomas shaking his head.
Thomas not known to fumble very often.
Watch number 99. The ball looked like somebody got a helmet right on the football, and that came free. Might have been Miguel Merritt, who's made a ton of tackles tonight. It is. It's loose in the pile.
You're right. And a helmet on the ball at the goal line. Huge play, Alabama defense.
I guess so. First down, Alabama. Zhao back in there at quarterback. Gives it off to Shaun Alexander. Trying to reverse his field, and he'll go down for no gain. James Hall made the tackle. Michigan did not turn the ball over much this year.
Second fewest in the nation. They only turned it over 12 times coming into this ballgame.
They were plus 10 on the turnover ratio, which was tied for sixth best in the country. And that was a costly one. Obviously, Lloyd Carr is aware of that. Alabama now has been held without a first down on three of their four second half possessions, so they're going to have to come up with something, too.
Well, Michigan is shutting down the run for the most part and forcing the quarterbacks to beat them.
Millen's in motion. Zhao drops back, has some time running out of it as he's hit. Incomplete. And a hit put on him by James Hall. He's the guy that normally applies pressure to the opposing quarterback. He led the club with seven sacks coming in, and he got a pretty good hit on number five.
Coming from the left side. Protection's pretty good up the middle until Ian Gold gets there.
With that hit, he just didn't get enough zip on that.
He had a man open. If he could have had a little bit more time to throw it.
Now it's third down and 10, Alabama. The key thing was they didn't allow Michigan to score, but now they still find themselves 10 yards from a first down. Three wideouts, as you include Shaun Alexander to the near side, and now McCadley goes back across the field.
Flips
screen to Carter, and Carter's got a first down. Antonio Carter, the freshman from Tallahassee. Dropped one earlier, he should have had. He picks up 16 on his first catch of the night.
That's their bread and butter play, a play that they have used a lot over the course of the season. Right here, you're going to have some guys blitzing. He's just going to come by, and all the offensive linemen are going to go downfield. Watch him get in behind the red shirts, right there, the wall. Right in here, and he just keeps going. That's the bread and butter play. They haven't used it much over the last two quarters, but they went back to it.
Bob, that's a first down for Alabama since there was 11 minutes left in the third quarter. Here's a pump fake by Zawa to come back to Millen's doing the same type of thing from the other direction. It's incomplete.
Exactly right. They tried to get it to Millen's coming the other way.
Michigan's offensive line hanging their head a little bit. They weren't involved in dropping the football. Anthony Thomas was, but a golden opportunity to take the lead in this game for the first time went by the boards. Terrell hoping to get his mitts on it another time. He's got three touchdown catches tonight. Might be whoever has the football last is going to win this thing. 28-28 with 11:05 to play. Brad Nessler, Bob Greasy, and Lynn Swann at the 66th FedEx Orange Bowl at Pro Players Stadium in Miami. Here's a toss to Millen. He wants to throw. Wanted to throw back maybe to Zao. Penalty marker down. And now he gets rid of it over to the Michigan bench. I thought Zao was going to be the intended receiver back to this.
I think you're right. I think you're exactly right. And Michigan had it covered.
And instead, just a flag. Millen's, you can see him looking back to the left side.
Yeah, he wanted to throw it back to Zao. The referee, McFerrin, sees a holding or a push in the back.
Collins, the wide receiver, number 7, is going to be the guilty party.
Had a lot of stuff going on there.
Yep.
That empty backfield, Millen's in motion. Throw back to Zao, penalty, minus yardage.
I think Lloyd Carr is trying to say, hey, that's supposed to be a spot foul, which would back him up even further. They still haven't spotted the football, so he might win that argument yet. They're talking it over. They still haven't put it down.
You know, it's only fitting that this game is 28-28. Big Ten versus the SEC.
Yep.
We've had two conference games today. Purdue went overtime against Georgia, and then the Michigan State-Florida game.
Last play of the game.
Oh, yeah. Both of the conference games between the Big Ten and the SEC have been great games.
Michigan State won it at the final gun on a field goal. Game you saw early today on ABC. And penalty markers again all over the place. Those flags are getting a workout.
Yeah, they are.
Dead ball. False start. On the offense. 5-yard penalty.
Well, Alabama just keeps backing up. That's 13 penalties against Alabama. Mike DeBoe's not happy about it. 9 of them have come on the offense. It's enough to drive a coach crazy.
And that's a killer. I mean, penalties are different. On the offense, they're drive killers. On defense, if they're aggressive, you can live with it.
Right. Zao from the shotgun. Here comes a blitz. He just got rid of it and got it to his tight end, Terry Jones, on the run. And Jones, his first catch of the night, is all the way back across the original line of scrimmage. Pick up a 15.
Unbelievable.
Whitley came on the blitz. 5 looking to bury number 5, and Zao got rid of it.
But normally, when you see a blitz, you throw in that direction. Here's Whitley coming right here. Watch the tight end. He's just going to slip back and catch a little outlet pass. Tight end screen.
Boy, that pass was thrown in some serious traffic.
Oh, yeah.
Right there. I don't know how I got it through there. And now it makes it 3rd down and 9. Let's see if they can pick up the first. Zao running for his life, flag down. It's going to be holding on Alabama as he delivers a strike for a 1st down. But I think they're going to bring it back. Holding Alabama. Wow. Another penalty on the offense. And this one negates a 1st down. It's a season high now, 14 penalties against Alabama.
Well, what's different about the Alabama offensive line?
holding.
They don't have Chris Samuels.
Samuels is out.
One pass play, 10 yards from the previous spot.
Two freshman tackles.
Yep.
Second down.
Ellington moved over from the right side to the left, and you've got two redshirt freshmen alternating at the other side.
Michigan with an injury in the secondary with 10:08 remaining in the game as we check in with Lynn Swan. Swanee?
Well, thank you very much, Brad. I'm with Chris Samuels right here. Chris, I know you're disappointed you're not in the ball game, but give us your evaluation of Dante Ellington, how he's playing.
Oh, he's playing very well. I think he stepped up and, you know, filled my shoes very well. He's playing well out there as far as him just taking on the defensive end on the pass protection. He's pass blocking very good out there.
All right. Now, give us the insight on what's happening with you, the injury to your knee.
Well, it's nothing serious as far as ligament damage or anything like that. Just a lot of swelling and fluid on the knee, and it's causing me a lot of problems right now. It's very painful also.
But I talked to the trainer. I was talking to you earlier. There's no arthritis that has been reported. None of that is in your knee?
Nothing is serious like that. No arthritis. It sounds like my old lady or something like that, or a man or something. But no, it's just tendonitis in my opinion.
Well, we know you're going to have a future in the NFL, but I'd like to ask you, if you had your pick of teams to play for, who would you play for and why?
I'm a 49er fan. I love Jerry Rice. I think he's a great guy as far as character and the playing talent on the field.
Well, you better call him up, say give Jerry one more year.
Oh, yeah, I wouldn't mind playing with him at least one time.
All right, Chris, thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
I know you're losing your voice a little bit here rooting for your team.
Oh, yeah, you got to excuse that. I've been hollering a lot out here tonight.
Thank you very much for joining.
Okay, you're welcome.
Chris Samuels. 317-pound Outland Trophy winner. And don't forget San Francisco and Atlanta on Monday Night Football. Well, I got
four wide receivers up here, Brad.
Third down at 20. Dow's going to go over the middle to Millen. See what he can do. Another flag down, though, in the backfield. Man, put those things away, guys.
Well, you got to call them if they're there. I mean, that's just... Yeah, it was a takedown.
That one, I think, on backslip.
Yeah, and that's where Chris Samuels, the loss of Chris Samuels forces Baxley to play.
On a pass play, 10 yards from the previous spot. Still third down.
Brad, let me show you this. You tell me if you have to call this or not.
Yeah, that's actually 2 points for a takedown.
And you told the referee, says, don't call those things.
Right.
Give us a break.
Yep, you got to call over.
he hasn't played a lot this season. He's in there because of the injury to Samuel.
Third down. Zhao back to his own five now, dancing around. Looking for somewhere to go with it. He'll decide to tuck it and run. And he's put down at the 25-yard line. Todd Howard, who was shaken up earlier, actually involved in the tackle.
Alabama's had 11 third down situations, and 7 of them have been third and 10 or longer. So you're not going to convert many of those.
That's right. So Patrick Morgan's going to have to punt. Diallo Johnson waits on the other end.
The whole momentum of this game seems to have changed a little bit.
Shifted to the maize and blue a little bit.
Yes, it has. And I think that part about wearing down and getting him into the fourth quarter might be around here.
Morgan, high kick. Johnson camps under it at the 38. Got by the first guy. Cut outside. Nice, efficient return to about the 45. Tie game, but remember, the comeback kid's going to have his hands on it when we come back.
Every morning, the future walks into my classroom. As a teacher, it's my responsibility to empower my students with every advantage. That's why we worked with Dell. Because of Dell's relationships with education software companies, the internet became a learning tool to kindle my students' imaginations. Nothing is more important than giving my students the knowledge they crave. Dell understands that.
Be direct. Dell. Dell desktops use Intel Pentium 3 processors.
New Dakota Quad Cab comes with a nice big bed and big back doors that lead to a great big cab for putting things you don't want outside, inside, and vice versa. Inside, outside,
Inside, outside. Inside, outside. Inside. Oops, that's better. Outside.
Dodge Dakota Quad Cab. Big room, big doors, big difference.
Just click and go.
The FedEx Orange Bowl. This ABC Sports exclusive brought to you by FedEx. FedEx, be absolutely sure. ADT, the power that protects more families than any other security company in America. Merrill Lynch, be bullish. And Dodge, in a perfect world, everything would be different.
Overhead shots courtesy of Goodyear, and our blimp is a Goodyear blimp, Stars and Stripes from Pompano Beach, Florida. Thanks to pilot Larry Chambers and the crew on board for giving us the beautiful shots at Pro Players Stadium tonight. Guys, safe travels. Thanks for being with us. First down, Michigan. Brady throws out to Terrell. He's hit immediately, and he's going to lose yardage. Nice play defensively by Alabama. Lewis got out there to make the hit, but Tom Brady, remember what he can do. 300 yards tonight, three touchdowns. He's hit eight different receivers, and he just seems to find ways in fourth quarters to get the job done. Well, here's another fourth quarter for the senior playing his final game with a winged helmet with 8:35 to go. There's his favorite target. Toss it to Anthony Thomas the other way. Got the corner, put his head down, got near midfield. In fact, he got to midfield. 28-28. Tom Brady, as Bob Greasy talked about in the open, almost left Michigan at one point. He talked with us about all the things he's overcome, especially maybe his own immaturity, and now his senior season.
I mean, I've learned so many things from playing football here, you know, just about myself and about, you know, how to you know, persevere. And, you know, even if I didn't, you know, the things didn't work out this year the way they did, I'm sure I still have been proud of myself that I stuck it out and played at one of the greatest schools, and the greatest school in the country.
He fires on third down, and he's got a first. Penalty marker in the backfield, though. Michigan had converted seven of their last eight third downs. They would have there as well. But it's a face mask call against Michigan on their offense for the second time tonight.
And that's an unusual call for an offensive lineman. But if you're getting beat and you're going to grab somebody, and that's the closest thing to grab, you've got to protect your quarterback.
And Brady threw a strike, but it's going to come back.
You know, we hate to see all the penalties, Brad, but the ones that, when we go back and we look for them, we're finding what they're calling. I mean, right. I'm sure these officials don't want to throw all these flags and slow down the game, but if they're there, you've got to call them.
Just amazing what a penalty like that can do. Now, keep in mind, this would have been a first down at about the 40.
Watch right here. Watch the right guard. No, didn't see it.
So now it's third down and 29. They're backed up to their own 28-yard line. Brady firing deep on the sideline. Off the fingertips of Marquise Walker. It would have been an acrobatic catch. And he almost made it.
He almost made it. Good coverage by Bailey. Bailey forced him to throw a perfect throw and catch. And they just couldn't pull it off.
This is how close it was to a first down. Just that much. Now it's time to punt and look out. Lightning wearing 15's waiting for it.
I'd punt it out of bounds.
So would I. Millen says everybody get out of the way. As it bounces, they do kick it away from him. It takes a great Michigan roll down to the 26-yard line.
I don't think Michigan could ask for anything better than that.
There's the senior captain waiting for another chance. He's scored three times already. Alabama on offense when we come back.
Your website's going to be set up like an MMDS gigabyte.
A website should be orderly.
I will give you art.
This is your webpage, baby.
Making website is like making good jam.
Developed with the highest in technology.
Got a hard drive.
Who wants some? Who wants some? Look at the kid.
Who designs your website is up to you. Hooking it up and delivering the goods, leave that up to us.
But of course, you'll ship everything.
FedEx.
Like a FedEx plane.
FedEx. Be absolutely sure.
Dodge Dakota brings you a startling new advancement. Doors. Great big ones. On the driver's side. And the passenger side. Each with windows that go all the way down. So what's the big deal about two great big wide opening doors? Nothing. But four is a different story. Real truck, real doors. Dodge Dakota Quad Cab. Different.
Bowl games. The only thing I don't like is those idiots that paint their faces in all those stupid colors. Don't they have any self-respect? What?
The history of two great teams. One, the winningest team of the last century. The other, 12 national championships under the legendary Bear Bryant. And here they are, deadlocked at 28. Shaun Alexander. And he goes out across the 30 to the 33-yard line, picked up about seven. This is where Alabama would like to give it to him for about seven more minutes and try to win the game.
Exactly. This is the drive right here, and they got a good start to it. Shaun Alexander picking up a very patient runner. I mentioned it earlier. He just lets the blockers do their thing, and then when it's finished with them doing their thing, then he starts doing his.
He's going to be a dandy of a professional football player. He's shaken up. That last hit seemed to have a hard time breathing when he got up a little bit. He's going to come out at least for a play. They put in Sean Bohannon. One Sean out, the other Sean in. Under 6.5 to play, and Alabama's got to take a timeout.
25-second clock was down to zero.
Part of that was getting their running back in the huddle and then finding out he wasn't feeling so good. So a timeout taken with 6:26 remaining in the football game. And we'll take a timeout as well. Michigan, Alabama tied at 28.
Okay, heads up. I'm quitting smoking. Again.
So, Dr. Jekyll, when should we expect Mr. Hyde?
You're looking at Hyde. I quit Saturday. This time, Nicoderm CQ.
Has Carol moved out yet?
No. In fact, she's tickled pink.
He does seem normal. Mm-hmm.
I am normal. This is CQ. Helps calm the cravings 24 hours a day, even when you first wake up.
Nicoderm CQ. The power to calm, the power to comfort, the power to help you quit.
Guys, relax.
It's the most remarkable garage in the world. The garage that invented an industry, that reinvented work with a few simple rules. Work quickly, no bureaucracy, just invent. For six decades, this garage has been the workshop of the world's inventors. It will be still, because the company that began in this garage will return to the rules of this garage. Watch.
Come on, girls.
Buddy, let's go.
Hello? Now we're almost there. Bye-bye. my God, yes. Did you see that?
Yeah, that's great. Now, look, now that your soap opera's over, can we put the bowl game back on?
Norm, see you Wednesday, 9:30, 8:30 Central on ABC.
6:26 to play. Welcome to Sunday. It's no longer January 1st. Second down and three, Alabama. Looking to put a drive together to try to win the 66th Orange Bowl. Here's a toss to Bohannon. Puts a stiff arm out there and gets run out of bounds. Looks like he might have the first down, though.
It'll be close.
Let's see where they spot it as a first down. Chris Samuels can only look on and be a 317-pound cheerleader right now. Alabama had a two-touchdown advantage in this game at one point. Michigan erased that. Shaun Alexander's back in there. He has three touchdowns tonight. Watts rolling, looking to throw, and does, and completes it. Jamari Buchanan makes the catch. Maybe just a little bit short of the first down. That's his first catch of the night.
Nice throw and catch. It's an overloaded, unbalanced line to the right side. He's got all kinds of blocking on that way. Roll out, have the outside guy run a deep out and come back. Get Watts outside the pocket.
The
receiver goes down about 20 and breaks down to about 15, and good completion.
And now they got second down and short. They can go back to the ground game if they want. High backfield behind Watts. In motion, and there's one of those big tackles. The young fella's moving again. Linus Baxley having a tough night. There'll be better days ahead for the redshirt freshman out of Waynesboro.
Mm-hmm.
But tonight, some struggles.
Well, Mike DeVos said that these five offensive linemen that started for him all year, the backups didn't play a lot because they were redshirt freshmen. And these kids that were in front of him were so good. Ellington was playing a lot and playing well. But if you have an injury to one, well, then you have to play these guys that you haven't played much.
26 penalties between the two teams, and a season high continuing to be added on to for Alabama. 16 tonight now. Second down and six. Watts from the gun. Carter in motion. They'll keep it on the ground of the draw play to Alexander, and he's got a first down and more. Down to the 49-yard line.
It's fun to watch him run.
Yes, it is.
He just kind of weaves. Whatever he needs to do, if he needs to, he's a little shifty, moves his feet away from you. If he needs to power over you, watch the way he moves his feet, one side to the other.
Hurt his ankle against Tennessee, as did Zhao, and then he missed a game, and that probably took him out of Heisman consideration, but certainly he is one of the very best skill position players in college football.
He's got such good footwork and such power. Tough to tackle.
First down, Alabama at the Michigan 49. Tied at 28, under five to play. And about a 1 yard, maybe two pickup before James Hall drops Alexander. That clock winding down. We said with the team that had the ball last win this football game, it may come down to that. 158 yards. Touchdowns of 5, 6, and 50.
Alabama has rushed for 193 yards. Michigan rushed for only 37. Four wide receivers at the top.
Empty backfield for Watts. Here he goes, but he's tripped up. Great shoestring tackle by Ian Gold.
Huge play by Gold because there was nothing but open pastures ahead of him.
He had about 20 yards in front of him. That would have been a huge run by the quarterback, you can bet.
Right there, the speed and quickness of Ian Gold prevented like a 15 or 20 yard gain.
Now it's third down and long. Alabama 30% on their third downs tonight, third and nine. Everybody, I think, cheering for both teams on their feet right now. Watts in trouble. Now he takes off, flags down, and he's going to pick up a first down, but I think it's coming back with a holding call.
The referee, Chuck McFerrin, has thrown his flag tonight more than he probably has thrown it in any game all season.
He's going to have rotator cuff surgery when this thing's over.
They get a new flag. I guess it's going to wear out.
And they'll bring it all back. Boy, that was a nice run by Watts.
Holding it was. On a run beyond the line, 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Still third down.
Mike DeBose looking down the barrel of the 17th penalty of his team tonight.
This might be on Shaun Alexander. Let's check. See right here? Yeah. Yeah, he's pulling. He's going for his flag. I don't know. I couldn't see anything really definitive.
Yep. 19-yard penalty. Now it's back to the 33-yard line.
That was from the spot of the foul.
Yep. Trips to the near side. Here comes a blitz on Watts. Look out. Down he goes. The helmet's gone. Whitley came flying in from the secondary. And Michigan's defense comes up with a big play.
Jim Herman, the defensive coordinator, sending his own blitz. Something that Michigan does more than anybody that Alabama has played. Take a look right here. These two guys, but it's going to be Whitley that gets there.
Remember, he almost took Zau's head off earlier in this half. And he actually took Watts' helmet off on that one.
You're going to blitz somebody with speed that can get there.
Morgan to punt. Not the greatest kick again. Might take a good bounce, though. It's going to take a great roll for Alabama. All the way down to the 32-yard line. Another look. The Michigan pressure got to the quarterback, and now the Wolverines have the football back with a chance to win.
Daddy.
My sweetie.
Can the monsters get me?
Not a chance.
When you've got ADT, you've got the power of advanced home monitoring technology.
Morning.
The power of experienced professionals helping to keep you safe.
Okay. Calling the fire department right now.
From burglary, fire, flooding, carbon monoxide, even the occasional monster. Call now and get ADT's sophisticated burglary system installed for as little as $99. Plus, get 2 months free monitoring.
And thank you for choosing ADT.
ADT helps protect more homes and families than any other security company in America. Call now and get the ADT burglary system from $99 installed. Plus, 2 months free monitoring. Sleep tight. Get the power of ADT.
Unleash power, sell more per hour, get business going. Keep it growing, change ammunition, kill competition. Unlock data, make profits fatter, take sharper aim, boost market gain. Save more time, more peace of mind, forge better ties, economize. Link devices without a crisis, our technology is hot, we are the dust.
1.6 times a week.
A new year.
Last year, it was 3.9.
A new resolution.
I need more sex.
An all-new practice returns ABC Sunday, January 9th.
This is the FedEx Orange Bowl.
If you want to join ABC Sports in Atlanta for the Super Bowl, watch Monday Night Football for all the details. This Monday night, the 49ers and the Falcons. Remember, you got to watch to win. Here's Michigan trying to win with 2 minutes remaining in the ballgame. And a guy that's been the comeback kid for him all year, licking his fingers and his chops maybe if he can pull out another come-from-behind victory from the 31-yard line. Brady, plenty of time, goes back to the left side, and it's complete. Out to Walker. And don't forget, Michigan had a chance to take the lead for the only time tonight in their previous possession in this quarter. They got down close and fumbled in the end zone. Now they're looking for another chance to get back there to at least get a field goal try.
Hurry up, offense. Here's a blitz.
Brady over the middle. Oh, he had a wide open receiver in Marcus Knight. He dropped it.
Yeah. He saw the blitz coming and wanted to get rid of it before he got sacked. And that's the value of the blitz. You don't have as much time. It's close. He dropped that long one down the sideline.
There have been a couple that should have been hauled in.
And yep.
Brady's had good numbers tonight. It'd be unbelievable that everybody held on to what they should have. Third down. A long two. Four wideouts for Brady. Looks to his left and goes that way and is complete. First down and out of bounds at the 45.
Big.
He's Walker.
Big first down there. Third down, you need to pick up a first down. All he does is get his outside receiver to go down and break to the outside.
And that first down right at the 45. Again from the shotgun is Brady. Stands in, waits, throws incomplete, and took a hit after he let go of that one. Cornelius Griffin got some pressure on him. Waited a long time before he let that one go.
It was a slow developing route that he was waiting on.
We talked about one of the key plays in this ball game, and it was with Michigan trying to get a chance to put it in the end zone. Anthony Thomas fumble. There's the ball. Loose. And Darius Gilbert right there, 99, scoops it. And it was a touchback. Alabama got the ball out at the 20. But Michigan still, with 1:23 left, has a chance to try to get it down in field goal range to win. Flag down, free play. And the pass completed. I think they'll take the penalty instead. That's about a 4-yard pass play and a 5-yard pickup on the penalty. It was Kendall Moorhead, I believe, that jumped in the neutral zone, which would be a new Orange Bowl record for one team in penalties. That'd be 18.
Oh.
1939, Tennessee had 17. And
defense
the year
in the
2000,
neutral zone, offside at the snap.
Alabama has 18.
Penalty. Still second down.
And Alabama is getting tired, as Swanee talked about earlier, yeah. I think.
And the longer that defense stays on the field, we're talking mainly about the big defensive linemen. There's Grimes and Griffin and the bigger guys, the guys that have to rush the passer, they slow down first.
So a second down and 5 at midfield. Here comes a blitz. Brady fires. Complete. He got that one to Marcus Knight. And
he held on.
The Alabama native holding on to maybe the biggest pass play of the night.
Held on to that long enough.
They're going to put it down at the 35. Stop the clock momentarily. Here's another look.
Marcus Knight has been their big play guy. That's a good catch.
Yes,
he had possession, even though he had it against his body. And then it came loose once he hit the ground. That was a good call.
Keep in mind, Aiden Epstein has hit from 56 yards this year. Brady on play action. Now it's the tight end. They won't have to worry about a long field goal. They're already inside the 20. Joan Thompson.
If there is ever a staple of the Michigan offense, it's that play right there. Fake to one side, roll away, and hit the tight end coming across.
Timeout taken by Alabama. As Thompson, the big sophomore, cartwheels his way inside the 20. And Michigan now very much in scoring range with 49 seconds to play. We talked about Epstein. 56 yards is his best. And they're way, way inside of that range for him. He had a 42-yard field goal against Ohio State that was big. Alabama trying to come up with something defensively. Our FedEx delivery of the game. And there's been some beauties, but how about this one? Freddie Millens.
I like
punt return. Turns down the speed. He got about there, and as Bob said, he's gone, and he was.
I like it.
62 yards. Our FedEx delivery of the game for Freddie Millens, but here's a guy that could still deliver Michigan its 10th win. Brady,
last game
back.
Last game for Tom Brady, fifth-year senior, going out in the last game for his offensive coordinator, Mike DeBoer.
We wish Mike the best with his new head coaching position.
He's taking a position at head coach at Western Michigan. Central Michigan.
Central. He told you if you said Western, he was going to be all over you.
I know.
He's got the chance.
I was just kidding. There he is.
There's Mike.
Scott Leffler right there next to him has been a graduate assistant. In fact, was a quarterback at Michigan and hurt his shoulder and was spent the time in the coaching office. And Mike DeBoer talked to my son, Brian. Says, Brian says, who helped you the most when you were at Michigan? Beside the coaches, he said, Scott Leffler. So Scott Leffler is going with him. And also Jason Carr, Lloyd's son.
Lloyd, that's right.
He's going to be on the staff.
A lot of great connections.
Central Michigan.
Tom Brady, almost a career high so far. 344-3. He's within about a pass completion of his career best. And it comes in his last game. First and 10, 49 seconds left. Michigan trying to get in position for a field goal. And they just give it to Anthony Thomas to go up the middle. Try to put it in the middle of the field. Kenny King made the stop. Remember, Michigan took over at their own 31 with 2:05 left.
See, I think this is not a time to get too conservative. I think you have to run plays where you're not going to turn the ball over, obviously. But this kick by no means is a gimme. If they're playing single coverage on the outside and you can throw a ball into the end zone, I would take a shot at it.
Brady comes all the way out to talk to Lloyd Carr. Now hustles back and you see the play clock.
They'll never get this off. They should take a timeout.
He comes up quickly. And he gets to the middle of the field on a quarterback sneak.
Yeah, that's it. They worked on that in practice the other day. And the whole line moves over to the left.
So you play for 4 hours in the 66th Orange Bowl. And it lands on maybe the smallest pair of shoulders on the football field. Lloyd Carr just shook hands with his kicker and said, go win it for us, will you? So Epstein will find a spot out there. He showed you his numbers from the regular season. A sophomore out of Cardiff, California. He's going to have a chance to be a hero. And there's the guy that definitely was a hero tonight, Tom Brady, along with David Terrell.
Shaun Alexander.
Yep, great game in his final appearance in the crimson uniform. It's down to one play. If he makes it, Michigan goes home with its 10th victory for the third straight season, something they haven't done since the Schembechler days. 76 through 78. If he misses it, they go to overtime in Miami. They're going to spot this at the 26-yard line. Tom Brady is the holder. After all the great passes he's thrown tonight, putting the football on the ground will be his most important task, and now Alabama will try to ice the kicker a bit. This is what happened earlier today. Florida calling a timeout with Michigan State looking for a final play to kick to win. And the ice melted as Michigan State won that game. Now Epstein continues to warm up. He's the loneliest guy in the stadium right now. Nobody's within 15 yards of him.
And you know,
he's at the 26-yard line.
Sometimes I think it works in the opposite direction. I think it gives him more time to settle down.
Alabama, the SEC champion. Mike DeBose, the SEC coach of the year, after a strange beginning to the season and offseason. His contract has been re-extended the 2 years that were taken off. He has the Alabama people excited about football again.
What were we saying the other day? Is when they talk about SEC championships, lately they've only talked about Tennessee and Florida. Now they're going to start talking about Alabama again.
So Rob Reines to snap, Tom Brady to hold, Hayden Epstein to try to win it for Michigan. From 36 yards, the kick is blocked. And now Brady throws a pass. We're going to overtime. Penalty markers on the play. Chris Horn, I think, is the guy that blocked it. Again, a flag down.
Ineligible downfield, decline, overtime.
It's the ineligible receiver on Brady's attempted pass. Alabama comes up with a miracle block on the final play of the game.
Right here.
Phillip Weeks.
Number 32.
Nice vertical leap. The kick blocked. And we're still tied at 28. 28-28. Overtime upcoming in Miami.
Your web page will even make you feel differently according to how it is positioned. For example, here, the yin is strong, coolness, peace. Whereas over here, the yang is there, powerful, hot. And now, up here, the computer's just happy.
Who designs your website is up to you. Hooking it up and delivering the goods, leave that up to us.
You'll ship everything. FedEx.
FedEx. Be absolutely sure.
In any business, there can be only one priority. At Morgan Stanley Dean Witter, we have never forgotten ours. Not surprisingly, we measure success a little differently.
Alabama blocks the would-be winning field goal, and we go to overtime. Tied at 28, and back to a busy set of officials at midfield. We're about ready to get the coin toss. So four quarters wasn't enough for Alabama and Michigan to start the new century. Our overtime rules, no sudden death. Teams get equal possessions. Offense starting on the opponent's 25, and you repeat that process until a tie is broken. If you get all the way down to that third OT, you got to go for two to try to finish the thing before it's 2001. Heck of a game, Bob.
Yes, it is. Michigan has had four field goals blocked this year. Two of Epstein's were blocked. And it didn't look to me like it was kicked real high, and it didn't look like it was real low. I think this, good jump on it.
This is what it's all about. Look at these guys. Smile at each other. Ready to do battle a little bit longer. Normally, you want to go on defense first. And that's what Alabama wants. If you go on defense first, you've got the opportunity to know what your opposition has done and what you need to do. Again, the play that saved the day for the Crimson Tide of Alabama. A 36-yard field goal by Michigan to try to win it at the final gun, blocked by Phillip Weeks. Now they get everybody sorted out as to which way they're going.
Alabama won the toss and elected to play defense. Michigan has elected to go at that end of the end zone. Into the field.
We're going to go down to our left. The reason we're going to overtime came down to one play. And Phillip Weeks with the play of the month. The blocked field goal.
It's the start of a brand new century.
The next millennium will be spectacular.
Time for one show that's ahead of its time. At All New Sports Night, Tuesday, January 11th on ABC.
Celebrating 2000. Channel 2 Action News all day, all night.
We will be here at the Y2K Command Center throughout the weekend.
Live Team 2 coverage from Georgia to Times Square and all around the world.
We've been preparing for this moment since 1996.
Channel 2 Action News salutes those who made Georgia Y2K ready.
When the clock rolled over, there were no problems.
Happy New Year, Georgia.
Channel 2 Action News, millennium coverage you can count on.
Now with Bell South Fast Access Internet Service. Faster downloads. Another solution with Bell South Nova.
He's at the plate. Here's the 2-2 pitch. That ball is out of here. And to think just 1 year ago, he was a shoe salesman with a dream and enough cash to buy his own batting cage.
What's your fantasy? Play Fantasy 5 from the Georgia Lottery 7 nights a week.
Anchors Monica Kaufman and John Brewitt, only on Channel 2 Action News.
Overtime at the 66th FedEx Orange Bowl. A first for the Bowl, not a first for these teams. Remember, Alabama beat Florida in overtime of the regular season. It's Michigan on offense first at the 25-yard line. Brady, nice play fake. Sets up, fires across the middle. His tight end's got it. Shaun Thompson, touchdown. Just like that, one play, 25-yard touchdown.
Great pitch and catch.
Talk about calling the right play and dialing it up perfectly.
Puts the pressure. This is the staple I talked about, the Michigan play. If they had one play they had to run, it would be this one.
Extra point now, all important by Epstein, who had the field goal blocked at the end of regulation. Should be a formality, and it is. One play into overtime, Michigan takes the lead for the first time tonight.
Alabama comes out and blitzes again. That means single coverage in the secondary. Watch the linebackers blitz. Here's the tight end as he's going to come across. Brady will roll, fake the run, and roll to his right. And right here, he's going to hit the receiver. Good throw and catch. Cox can't make the play. Touchdown, Michigan.
And a career high for Tom Brady in both yardage and now touchdowns. His fourth touchdown pass of the night.
And I understand, Bob, the theory in terms of when you win the coin toss going into overtime. But as I pointed out prior to this, it's a fact that the defense was on the field the whole time. Prior to overtime, they were pretty tired.
That's a good point, Swanee. Here's a give on a little draw play to Shaun Alexander from the shotgun formation, and he got about four.
Wasn't it in the first play against Florida in overtime when Alabama, they gave it to Shaun Alexander? Maybe not the first play, but he's the one.
Right,
he
away.
Ran it in for a touchdown.
Yep.
I'd give it to him, too.
So now it's second down at six in overtime. Michigan leading for the first time tonight. And if their defense can come up with three more plays, they'll take home the Orange Bowl trophy to Ann Arbor.
You can make first downs in this situation.
They can get a first down at the 15.
Right.
And now timeout taken by Zhao, and that's the only timeout Alabama's got. So we'll take a timeout as well. We're in overtime, Michigan, leading by a touchdown.
People are beginning to think of the automobile not just as a family vehicle, but as a personal and individual means of transportation.
The job of a powerful engine.
Now for a moment, imagine yourself as driver of this automobile.
You really have to drive it.
At the Chrysler Proving Ground,
give them an expressway, and their drivers are willing.
I think we make the scenic back roads fun to drive.
I'll give them any country or suburban road, rough or smooth.
They're the type of people who like the feel of a flying machine.
Love to drive.
The renowned engineers of Chrysler.
A minimum of ornamentation and a minimum of chrome molding.
Need a regular firecracker.
The sounds of nature sing their prettiest over the rich, throaty obbligato of his engine.
Even sheet metal can have a soul.
And they give you back the romance of driving.
And that is why these will never land on an ordinary car.
And you find out what exceptional unity of man and machine has been achieved.
Shannon Sharp, please, has always talking trash.
Japan, baby!
He's always trying to get inside your head.
Seahorse, you don't know your elbows from your...
And sometimes, he can get downright nasty.
I bet you pay transaction fees on your mutual funds. Your mama pays full commission. You know how to calculate a P.E. ratio.
When we created a smarter kind of investment firm...
How diversified is your portfolio?
We created a smarter kind of investor.
You can't even spell Dow Jones.
Woo! Okay, guys, let's get this right. To calculate a P.E. ratio, you divide the stock price...
very soon to be a four-hour football game. Michigan in overtime leads Alabama. Tide's got it, second and six. At the Michigan 21, they need a touchdown. Zion lost one, wide open, touchdown, Carter. Great play fake to Alexander, and he hooks up with a freshman. There's a little bit of that Alabama offense we talked about at the beginning of the game.
Nice call by Charlie Stubbs, the offensive the quarterback coach. Fakes it to the franchise, Shaun Alexander. Everybody comes up to make the tackle and easy touchdown.
That pass couldn't get to Carter fast enough. Flugner now to try to send this game further. Did he miss it? He did! Michigan wins in overtime. Alabama won a game in the regular season against Florida because of a missed Gator extra point. Fate has dealt them an ugly blow in this Orange Bowl.
Not the way you want this game to end.
What a game it was. And a dramatic finish as Michigan wins its 10th game of the year. Tom Brady, four touchdown passes. Three of them to Terrell is the guy that led the way. Here's the final play in overtime. Luger just pushed it to the right. Former walk-on, now one of the captains. You know how terrible he feels.
Good snap and good hold.
Wasn't to be. And Mike DeBose.
They've had a great year.
Yes, they have.
They've had a great year. Nobody.
And the jubilation of the Michigan sideline and Lloyd Carr as they win their 10th game against two losses. Alabama 10-3 to finish. And both these teams will be in the thick of things to try to get back here to Pro Players Stadium next year. In overtime, the final score, Michigan 35, Alabama 34. We'll be back with more in a moment.
The 300 Secret. At Chrysler, the latest 300 is unveiled.
The 300 philosophy has always been one of styling leadership. Presenting the newest 300.
Chrysler 300M, the 253-horsepower descendant of the legendary Letter Series. Chrysler 300M. Car and driver's 10 best 2 years running.
Every year I say, I'm going to quit smoking. Day later, I'm at it again. Till this year. See this? My last piece of Nicorette gum. Been smoke-free with Nicorette now for 12 weeks. With Nicorette, I help control my cravings two ways. I used it on a regular schedule to help curb them. And then for unexpected cravings, I took another piece. And now, no more craving, no more nicotine. Happy New Year.
For a better quit date, you'll have to wait another 1,000 years. You can do it. Nicorette can help.
Ladies and gentlemen, your starting 5'7" Patrick Ewing. 6'11" Marcus Camby. 6'7".
They forgot to change the floor again.
Now there's a whole new way to snack and kick back. Introducing single-serving Tostitos snack kits. Just be sure you pick the right time to eat them. Dig in, kick back, Tostitos.
Ewing, live to the hoop.
Want to upgrade your workout for the new millennium? Right now, during the best time to buy, get 0% financing till July 2000 on all treadmills priced $599 and above when you use your Sears card. Take this foldable ProForm EKG treadmill featuring power incline. It's only $599.99. You save $200. Sears, the good life at a great price. Guaranteed. Sears is the proud sponsor of the BCS and the Sears National Champion Football Trophy.
In overtime, Michigan wins it in a massive humanity of blue and maize down there with a winning coach, I think, is Lynn Swann. Swanny?
Brad, we're right here with Lloyd Carr. Lloyd, a phenomenal second half for your football team.
Well, Lynn, it's a great football game, and it's a shame somebody has to lose. And as happy as I am to win, I hate to see it end the way it did with a missed extra point. But I am so proud of the guys on this football team because if you're lesser caliber men, you got a lot of chances to quit in there, and they never quit. They never kept fighting, and they've done that all year long. You know, I'll be glad to get rid of them because I don't have much heart left.
Well, Coach, congratulations. I know you're not glad to get rid of these guys. They're terrific. Congratulations to you.
Thank you, Lynn.
And Swanee, thank you, partner, and Robert as well. It's been a fun year.
Enjoyed it, Brad.
Boy, what a way to finish. To our entire crew, thanks, everybody, for a great season. Final score in overtime, Michigan 35, Alabama 34. ABC Sports is online at ESPN.com, part of the GO Network. This has been a presentation of ABC Sports, continuing the tradition of excellence. Good night, everybody.
Promotional consideration provided by National Car Rental, the official car rental company of the Bowl Championship Series on ABC.
Let's go!
Two undefeated teams, one national championship. Number one Florida State takes on number two Virginia Tech. Michael Vick and Virginia Tech have been a Cinderella story, but the Noles plan on giving Bobby Bowden his first undefeated season.